final purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports Chelsea Manning, the former U.S. Army private serving 35 years in prison for leaking government documents, said she was found guilty on 4 charges of prison misconduct, though she was spared the possible sentence of solitary confinement. Manning tweeted about the results of her hearing with the prison board Tuesday, saying she was found guilty on all 4 charges. Manning was charged with disrespect, disorderly conduct, prohibited property, and medicine misuse by officials of the U.S. Disciplinary Barracks, the maximum security military prison in Fort Leavenworth, Kansas, where she is serving time for charges including violating the Espionage Act. She wrote, "I was found guilty of all 4 charges at today's board. I'm receiving 21 days of restrictions on recreation, no gym, library, or outdoors." Books and magazines were found in Manning's cell, prompting the charge of prohibited property. Books recovered include I Am Malala by Malala Yousafzai and Hacker, Hoaxer, Whistleblower, Spy, The Many Faces of Anonymous by Gabriella Coleman. Magazines confiscated include the Vanity Fair Call Me Caitlin issue with Caitlyn Jenner on the cover, and a Cosmopolitan with an interview of Private Manning. The medicine misuse charge was imposed for an expired tube of toothpaste. Manning said the disciplinary action will likely add years to her sentence when it comes time for parole hearings. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports hackers have followed through on a threat to release online a huge cache of data, including customer information that was stolen a month ago from cheating spouse's website, AshleyMadison.com. Several tech websites reported on Tuesday the data was posted on the dark web, meaning it is only accessible using a specialized browser, although vast lists of hundreds of email addresses, including many links to corporations and universities, sprouted up on other sites hours after the news broke. The hackers, who call themselves the Impact Team, leaked snippets of the compromised data in July and threatened to publish names and salacious details of as many as 37 million customers unless Ashley Madison and EstablishedMen.com, another site owned by Toronto-based parent company Avid Life Media, were taken down. While other high-profile attacks, such as those on big companies like Sony Pictures Entertainment and Target, have seen credit card data of customers stolen, this attack appeared to confirm that the hackers were not driven by blackmail or commercial motives, but rather ideological. Identifying customers on Ashley Madison, which uses the slogan, "Life is short, have an affair," could have far-reaching consequences for individual people. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Retail giant CVS is gearing up for floods of customers seeking the perfect meaningless piece of crap for their office gift swap. The company is making no secret that when it comes to wasting the obligatory $20 on a useless electronic dartboard or pretzel maker for someone you couldn't care less about, CVS is your best option.
Our incredible selection of worthless shit is just the thing that nobody wants. We guarantee you'll find nothing personal or unique in our store.
The company is offering massive discounts on otherwise unsellable items for holiday parties you don't even want to go to, like the $12 decorative lantern, which is expected to be a big hit with customers who grab the first thing they see when they walk in the store.
I really wanted to get something that said, "I don't care about any of you people and I didn't put any effort into this."
CVS also has shitty Hanukkah gifts for coworkers who you think might be Jewish, like candles and those little plastic net bags full of chocolate money.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves. We'll give you the toll-free numbers here in a bit. Also, our Skype username. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
Tarrin P. Lupo.
And Mark.
There is some pretty crazy news happening out of, I believe it is Denver. And Tarrin, you've got the story. A man has been charged with felonies for doing something that here in New Hampshire we do on a monthly basis. Some activists in New Hampshire do every 2 weeks here, and that's jury nullification outreach. Tarrin, where did this happen? Was it Denver? And this, what happened?
This is out of Raw Story is the source. And Denver man charged with 7 felonies for handing out jury nullification flyers outside the courthouse.
They'd have charged him for flowers, too.
A Denver man has been charged with multiple felonies after he was caught distributing flyers to educate potential jurors about the practice of jury nullification.
Now, what is
Do you guys want to explain that first?
Mark? Well, jury nullification is a thousand-year-old right. This has been around as long as there have been English common law juries. Is the right of the jury to decide not only whether the person is innocent or guilty of a crime, but to decide whether or not the thing they're being charged with should be a crime at all. A juror has an inviolable right to decide the guilt or innocent of somebody on a moral basis, too.
If they don't like the law itself, they can vote to acquit.
Right. I mean, you know, like, what is legal is not a very good arbiter of what is right, or at least it is certainly not 100% of the time the truth. Slavery, legal. Gassing Jews, legal. The slaughter of American Indians, legal. All these things were legal. They were just wrong.
Absolutely. Tarrin, let's continue.
Sure. The Denver Post reported that a 56-year-old man, Mark Iannicelli, set up a small booth with a sign reading juror info outside the Lindsay Flanagan Courthouse in Denver last week.
Mistake number one, he was alone. Unless he had other people with him, it's not saying that that he did. Sounds to me like this guy is a lone wolf activist in Denver. There should be more than one person who can come out. And maybe he didn't reach out to anybody. Maybe he doesn't know anybody else in the Denver area.
Or didn't think it was worth doing.
A local group or something like that. I guess, Mark, I mean, if you think you can just go down and tangle with the state all by your lonesome, you really haven't been paying attention.
A few years back, I remember when George Donnelly and the guy that moved
Jim
away.
Babb in
Philly? The old guy that used to do it all the time.
Oh, yeah, Julian Hyklin.
Julian Hyklin.
The heroic jury nullification activist who went around to so many different courthouses, federal courthouses all around the country, and handed out jury nullification information from the Fully Informed Jury Association. He ended up leaving the country and seeking asylum in the Middle East.
Yeah, he went around alone all the time and got arrested about every time he went out alone. So
seems about right. Yeah, I remember when he came here to New Hampshire, there were 40 people who came out to support him. So he was definitely not alone here.
Yep. All right. Where were we at here?
the Denver story.
Yeah, the Denver District Attorney's Office charged Iannicelli with 7 counts of juror tampering after members of the jury pool were found to be in possession of flyers describing jury nullification.
Okay, so jury tampering. My understanding of this, now I don't know how the law or the ordinance or whatever is, statutes are written in Denver or Colorado, but the idea of tampering with a jury, my understanding, and I'm no lawyer, is that you're trying to get the juror to do something specific. You want that juror to vote guilty or not guilty, and you are doing something, whether it's trying to persuade them verbally or with, you know, cash reward or whatever it is, to persuade that person to do as you wish. All a jury nullification advocate is doing is attempting to give information to a juror. They're not asking the juror to vote not guilty. In many cases, a jury nullification activist doesn't even necessarily know what cases are being called in the courthouse. They just know that this is the jury selection day. Okay, let's go and do some jury outreach on this particular day because you're more likely to reach actual jurors when you go on that day.
Yeah, mostly, I believe that the jury system in the United States is broken. The juries.
This is proof.
Yeah. The juries. Well, no, the jurors haven't decided that this person is innocent or guilty yet, but they likely would. If a prosecutor brings them up on jury tampering charges, it's my belief that even if they take it to a jury trial and they can show the law says specifically what you've just said right now, Ian, that one has to try to get a jury to vote one way or the other, that the jury will still find them guilty simply because they're told to. Because, I mean, and I'm sorry to sound trite, this is a nation of sheep. It's a nation of sheep that so thoroughly trusts its government, it's willing to throw people into the toothy maw of the state simply to justify their own beliefs that it still works.
You know, we've seen that happen in more than one occasion. We've seen a jury out in California throw a guilty verdict at the Bartholomew brothers, even though it was proven and the jury admitted that they didn't actually break any law. They threw the book at them because they just didn't like that they didn't do what the cops asked them to do. They were doing
it
as protest.
The cops asked them to do something above and beyond what the law said. The Bartholomew brothers showed the cops the law, showed everybody the law, and nobody cared. They just found them guilty. This also happened with a Damo Freeman here in New Hampshire, where he was caught on a wiretapping charge, and they found him guilty of a felony. And even if you liberally interpret the misdemeanor law, he was only guilty of a misdemeanor.
That's correct. That was overturned eventually in the Supreme Court,
but
as a matter of fact.
But the jurors did it anyway.
Yes. Yeah. The prosecutor went ahead with illegal charges, and the jurors found that person guilty of those
illegal
charges. They'll
do whatever the prosecutors say.
Almost.
What was the case a few years back where I remember where the jurors actually wore red, white, and blue?
Oh, God. Wasn't that Jose Padilla?
Where the jurors actually sent a message to the person on trial, like that was fair at all. That they wore, for people who don't know.
Wait, didn't they also do that in Bernard von Nothaus's trial as well? Did the guy from the Liberty Dollar?
I don't know.
I can't remember that one, but I do remember. I mean, how could you have an unbiased jury when they're wearing red, white, and blue instructed by the prosecutor?
That's crazy.
I mean, that's ridiculous. It's so insulting.
So jury nullification is not, you know, it's not criminal activity, but apparently in Denver, Colorado, they're acting like it is.
Yeah, let me pick up here. A copy of the criminal complaint obtained by Kristen Tynan of the fully injured... I'm tongue-tied
sounds
tonight.
Nasty.
Of the fully informed jury association says, and Ayanna Selly unlawfully and maliciously attempted directly and indirectly to communicate with seven jurors.
I do that all the time here in New Hampshire when I'm out doing jury outreach. I will frequently ask people if they're here for jury duty. I'll specifically, you know, single people out who are there for jury duty, and then I will hand them a flyer for, you know, explaining their right of jury nullification. It's not illegal to talk to a juror, at my understanding at least. You know, you can go and talk to a juror. They're not supposed to tell you about the case, but you can certainly go up to them and say, "Good morning. Would you like some information about your rights?"
Well, these judges can do whatever they want. They did it down in Florida with
That's true.
I can't remember.
There was a gentleman in Florida, who was arrested. Actually, about the same age as this guy. Another sort of middle-aged gentleman who's really interested in jury nullification. He was arrested. What did they keep him for? 6 months?
I think it was six months.
In prison?
Over telling jurors their own right, the rights they've had for 1,000 years. It's crazy.
Tell me more, Tarrin Lupo.
Sure. A probable cause statement added that Ayanna Selly was accused of handing out information to potential jurors. Tynan pointed out that the complaint does not accuse Mr. Inaselli of advocating for or against any case in the process.
Okay.
And it does not accuse Mr. Ianicelli of even targeting individuals for sharing information with him. The charges don't discuss specifically what Mr. Ianicelli is accused of doing, but rather seem to regurgitate the language of the statute which he was accused of violating.
I sure hope this guy, and there's more to talk about this, we'll get to it here. I sure hope this guy has his charges dropped, because this is absolutely outrageous. I'll see if I can pull up the actual statutes from Denver or the
I've got
Colorado.
It.
You do? Okay,
yes.
Good. All right, we'll share that coming up with you. You can join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Skype in here at username lrn.fm or Free Talk Live. Coming up, you can take control.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallow Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Keenvention.info. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Talk Live, and you can join us here on the radio. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're talking about jury nullification and what should be your right to free speech. You should have the right, the freedom of speaking in front of a courthouse to the people who are walking into that building. Now, there are jury tampering statutes that could possibly apply based on the content, I suppose, of that speech. And what we're sharing with you tonight here, Tarrin Lupo's in the studio with Ian and Mark. Tarrin, what you're sharing with us tonight is about a man who was arrested. How old was this guy?
56.
56 years old. He went to do some outreach because he cares about jury nullification. He cares about you knowing your right to judge the law, the case, based on your opinion of the law. You can vote not guilty if you just think the law itself is bad. So like with the war on drugs, if I were on a jury, which I'll probably never be on, I would vote to acquit the person.
Probably not.
As long as they didn't hurt somebody else. I'd vote to acquit that person. If there's no fraud, if there's no actual harm to another person, that's jury nullification. And this guy was trying to explain that to folks, and he's been charged with 7 felonies. Can you pick up the story?
Yeah. I was talking about earlier about how the charges actually didn't specifically say what he did. It just, they just threw a CRS at him. So I'm going to pick it up.
CRS?
The statute.
The statute.
I see.
Colorado Revised Statutes, I believe.
I've heard it as another thing.
Yes, I get that sometimes. All right. The charges don't discuss specifically what Mr. Iannacelli is accused of doing, but rather seem to regurgitate the language of the statute, mm-hmm. which he is accused of violating, and then claim that he violated it, Tynan said.
That's pretty typical for a charging document.
It's like, we're going to arrest you for something, and we'll figure it out later. I know it's wrong. I see nothing in the statement of probable cause sustaining these accusations, Tynan continued. These charges allege that Mr. Iannacelli acted with the intent to influence a juror's vote, opinion, decision, and action in a case, but nowhere in the statement of probable cause did I see anything that indicates as such.
See, this is one of those things. If they want to prove intent, in theory, it should be difficult to do that. However, if a judge decides that you had the intent, then they can find you guilty. I went through this last year with a criminal trial for some nonsense paperwork snafu that happened here in New Hampshire to me. And here's the actual full definition of jury tampering. Section 1 of the CRS code that you were talking about there, Tarrin, is a person commits jury tampering if, with intent to influence a juror's vote, opinion, decision, or other action in a case, he attempts directly or indirectly to communicate with a juror other than as part of the proceedings in the trial of the case. So you have to have that intent. If you don't have the intent to influence their vote or their opinion or decision and such, then it's not tampering. And the state's going to have, I think, a difficult time arguing, although, Mark, you know, you're critical of the juries, and I think rightfully so. I think the state should have a difficult time arguing that he had the intent to influence the jury. He could claim he didn't even know what the cases were in the courthouse in that particular day. Giving information.
Well, it says to influence their decision, right?
That's correct.
So could one make the argument that what the words mean? Remember that laws are constantly evolving for sort of what is, you know, what's current.
They're being reinterpreted.
Reinterpreted. Yeah. You can see it all the time with Supreme Court interpretations. I think one of the great ones is sort of the Brown versus Topeka, Kansas versus Plessy versus Ferguson. So at one point, separate but equal was fine when it came to bathrooms and drinking fountains for white people and black people. Then later, decades later, separate is no longer considered equal because we saw the application of it and it's just not considered equal. So, you know, either one decision was wrong or one decision and one decision was right, or they changed over time. And I think that the reality is that sort of people's attitudes change over time. And so if for whatever reason, remember, this is going to be decided by government bureaucrats, judges and prosecutors, not by jurors, because whatever case gets put in front of a juror is going to get found. They're going to get found guilty. And that's the going to be that. And so if they decide that, look, this rule, this right of jury nullification, which has you know, a thousand-year history in English common law, it just, it's no longer applicable into today's society, right? Like, gay people couldn't get married up until recently. Now they can, because that's applicable and that's the way things go. So if they decide, well, we've changed our mind, this just no longer is a right, because the average citizen, there's no way they can understand the law. They haven't gone, they're not a doctoress in jurisprudence. They're not a doctor in jurisprudence. They don't know these things. We're going to have to leave this to experts. The experts are the lawyers that are in the legislature, the lawyers that are in the judicial branch, and the lawyers who do the prosecuting and the lawyers who do the defending. These people, lawyers are experts in law. We should leave it to the lawyers, as though the lawyers won't rob us blind and leave us with a country that is a heaping, smoking mess that, you know, once they walk away with their money stuffed with our, their pockets stuffed with our money.
Yeah, this is a real important crux of a decision to make in this case. Because certainly the state is going to argue that, well, he did have intent to influence the juror's opinion or decision simply because he was giving them information. Obviously, he had the intent to influence them, and he would probably argue that, no, he didn't. He just wanted to give them information. Giving someone information about their rights in a courtroom shouldn't be considered attempting to influence them. But it certainly could be, and I think that's the point you're making, Mark, is that the jury and then the judges who ultimately judge that decision later will likely, or they could likely, rule against the ability to communicate with jurors in any way, shape, or form. And that's a scary idea.
Yeah, well, it's I see it coming. Have you ever heard of a judge or a prosecutor that likes jury nullification?
I don't know. I don't know if you would be able to ascertain whether they like it or not unless you could actually ask them about it. But I have seen here in New Hampshire, prosecutors explain jury nullification to a jury. So
it was coming up in the trial.
Well, that's because it can come up in a trial here in New Hampshire. In some places, even mentioning jury nullification could get you hit with a mistrial. There could be serious, you know, consequences.
New Hampshire is special in that sense. Okay, so let's go ahead and understand that New Hampshire is part of a greater union, and that there are 49 states that aren't special like New Hampshire is, Ian.
That's true.
And that those 49 states, those prosecutors and those judges have a lot more sway when in aggregate over, you know, the courts in around the country than New Hampshire does. And so that we've seen people arrested. We've seen Julian Hyland arrested on multiple federal
court
steps.
Not in New Hampshire.
Not in New Hampshire.
Right.
In multiple federal court steps. We have seen a guy go to jail, Mark Zimmer or something like that. I can't remember his last name to save my life. Down in Florida for handing out jury nullification information. We've seen an arrest here in Colorado, in Denver. And it seems to me that, you know,
they don't want to let you get away with this. They want to crack down as hard as they possibly can. And even if they ultimately have to drop the charges, it's
they
not
still win.
Yeah,
right.
They still put you through the ride.
Exactly. It's not necessarily the case that there will be any kind of civil lawsuit that will be successful, because it's very difficult to sue the state. 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number, 855-450-3733. More coming up on this jury nullification arrest.
Are you excited about the World Wide Web? Do you want a place where you can share your ideas and express yourself? Well, dial up your modems and stream on down to the GCN Live Community Forum. Lots of radical features await you there.
Wow, Internet guy, I am so glad I went to the GCN Live Community Forum.
You too can discover why the World Wide Web is awesome. Just go to gcnlive.com/forum. That's gcnlive.com/forum. I'll see you in cyberspace. Friend GCN Live on Diaspora and Cross.tv.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
Negotiation isn't just something union leaders and sports agents do. Your entire day is a series of negotiations. If you have young children, you know that. In fact, your kids can teach you a lot about negotiating with grown-ups. According to the world's greatest negotiator, Herb Cohen, author of You Can Negotiate Anything. Herb says that kids understand the process of decision-making within an organization. When one parent says no, they'll ask the other. And Cohen says children persist and persevere. And like smart negotiators of all ages, kids know that no is an opening bargaining position. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is up $10 at $1,128 per ounce. Silver is 36 cents higher at $15.30 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $232. Not writing Bitcoin down on the block size controversy doesn't mean you don't like Bitcoin. Use it to buy silver and swap back at the bottom. Call us at 800-874-9760 or online at rrbi.co.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
Do you guys have a zombie plan? I'm just wondering what this country's going to do if we had some sort of apocalypse like that.
Like a
what
zombie
are we
attack.
Gonna do?
People coming
yeah,
out
like
of the ground, like in Thriller,
or,
like in Michael Jackson's Thriller.
No, like 28 days later, like a virus or something.
Oh, okay.
I mean, people don't come back to life.
Well, now, there are different kinds of zombies out there.
Now,
but let me go through the types of zombies. I mean, you've got the ones that can crawl out of the ground, right? And then she was talking about like an infection kind of zombie, mm-hmm. like a la Resident Evil, for instance. So ideally, if you're going to have to perish at the hands of a zombie, which would be the preference? Would you prefer to have your brains eaten, or would you prefer to become one of them?
I think I'd rather just die. The last thing I'd want is, of course, the people you split up with. Then I'm talking my wife and my child. I'm coming back. I'm wanting to eat Laura's brains. It's bad. It's bad.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Apparently, Colorado government guys would like you to believe that you can't talk to jurors. You can't give them information about their rights. I mean, this seems like basic freedom of speech to me. You know, if you don't know something about jury duty and somebody's out front of the courthouse who's willing to fill you in about what your rights are in all of the U.S. government's court systems, jury nullification is an established right of a juror. That should not be illegal, and it certainly should not lead toward multiple felony charges, as one man in his 50s is now facing, and we're going to continue that discussion. But you're welcome to join us here at 855-450-FREE. Maybe you think it is jury tampering, as the government goons are claiming. You can share your thoughts here. We've got Skype as well. You can Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm. And Bitcoinist.net is the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. Their website at Bitcoinist.net integrates a community forum, breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news, and they aim to cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. Bitcoinist has sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and more. The Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies from beginners to experts. Just go to Bitcoinist.net.
So, Tarrin, you're sharing with us details from the raw story where this man in his 50s is facing felony charges, presumably leveled by Colorado. I don't think they said he was at a federal courthouse. I think this was the Denver.
This sounded like a state house.
Okay.
All right, and it just continues a little more here. Nothing I have heard from any of the local people who saw the arrest and or know Mr. Iannacelli indicate that he was doing anything other than fully informing people about all the options jurors have. Iannacelli was released on a $5,000 personal reconnaissance bond.
Oh, he had a court date shortly thereafter, which apparently has actually transpired. I wonder if we can find an update on this particular story.
I've been looking, but I haven't been able to find anything. I don't know if this went all the way out.
Once again,
he might be settled or they dropped it.
This is a dropped ball. If something has been dropped, it's been dropped on the part of whoever the Liberty community is in Colorado. I mean, look, at some point, this story must have gotten on your radar, right? If you are people who care about freedom and you're in Colorado and you heard about this story, did you reach out to the man? Did you attempt to, you know, help him? Maybe give him some support in Denver? There's got to be somebody in Denver who can show up at a courthouse to support another person. You know what I mean? I mean, this is like basic activism here. And
well, you drag people away from, 49 other states to come to New Hampshire, yeah. And then you complain that those states don't have liberty activism. And
you and I both know, Mark, that there are liberty people in other states. Some of them, yeah. You know, they say things like they don't want to go, they want to leave, they want to stay where they live, and their family lives there, and there's a job.
Are they really liberty activists then?
Yeah, there's definitely activists in other states.
Whether they're effective or not is another question. And you are not as effective as you can be if you're not with other people who care about freedom. And this guy's a perfect example of this. He's out there alone in Denver, Colorado. I don't know how many millions of people are in Denver off the top of my head, but I bet you it's at least one or two.
Several, I would guess.
So yeah. There should be a handful of people at the very minimum who support jury nullification. And of those people, at least one other one should be able to go out and accompany this poor guy. Because if there's more than one person at a location, it makes it harder for the police to bully somebody. And that's what they do.
Yeah, and if they had got this on film, it would have been blown up everywhere.
Yeah. I bet it is on video. It's probably on the security cameras from the courthouse.
The city of Denver is less than a million, but the surrounding area gets...
more than.
Yeah.
Right. So, I mean, look, I don't think it's too much to ask to say, hey, why hasn't this guy gotten support? I mean, maybe he's a total a-hole, and people who've tried to support him, he's just been so rude to them. I don't know, right? Like, I don't know. Maybe there's a good reason why he hasn't gotten the support. But there should be somebody who went to court and wrote a blog post about what happened to this guy. You know, what, Fija. There's not another Fija activist within an hour's drive of this city? Really? Is it that bad out there?
It's that bad out there. It's obviously that bad out there.
Yeah,
I kind of feel like the energy's died down a lot.
Look what happened
since
with
Ron Paul.
I think so, because I remember in 2008, you could shake a stick and get 20 activists to show up to something like this. Where now you can scream about it on Facebook or whatever, and nobody calls, nobody cares.
Look at the Ross Ulbricht trial in New York City. How many of the people that were out there at the Ross Ulbricht trial were from New Hampshire? I mean, we were shipping them to. I'm just saying, as a percentage, I think it was about half of the people were regularly covering that trial.
There were about 5 or 8 people or something like that who went down.
There were some that covered it, that were not from New Hampshire, but. It just goes
John
to
and
show.
Kat were there from Austin, Texas.
Right. Texas, New
Philly,
Jersey, Canada. I mean, the people.
But not really from Manhattan. I mean, there might have been one or two people there, but I don't know who they are.
Yeah, but they weren't certainly coming as consistently.
So what you're pointing out here is that there is a real dearth of activism out there, that there just isn't a whole lot of it. And that's, of course, one of the reasons why the Free State Project is such an important idea. Now, that's not to say that this guy doesn't have support, and I think that maybe what he'll see happen is some attorney types might come up to defend him. Maybe Fija can help him kind of keep the ball rolling on this. But a lot of liberty-loving people are moving to New Hampshire, and in fact, there's a really great jury outreach movement here. There is an incredibly robust jury outreach movement that just within the last 6 months has blown up. It was maybe two or three counties that were doing jury nullification outreach here, which is probably already more than in most places. Two or three counties. Now it's up to like six or seven, and there are only 10 counties in New Hampshire. So we're getting very, very close to actually having...
Every county, every time.
That's correct. Total coverage of every jury selection date where there are people who are out front, you know, friendly, smiling people who are out front of the courthouse handing out nhjury.com flyers because we've got our own jury organization here in New Hampshire. FIJA's great. Don't get me wrong. If you're outside of New Hampshire, check out the Fully Informed Jury Association. They do great work, and they absolutely inspired the creation of nhjury.com. So anyway, we've got activists out there handing out flyers, and they're doing it consistently. They're welcoming people to court. They're smiling, you know, giving out useful information about their rights. And I haven't heard anything at all in these recent busy months with a lot of outreach going on at these courthouses. I haven't heard anything at all about any real harassment by the government bureaucrats.
Well, didn't you all, aren't you all one of the only states that actually passed a bill allowing, you know, that you guys had a jury nullification bill pass about 2 years ago. Tell us more about that, because I'm new here and I don't know the details.
Yeah, there was a bill that passed and it got watered down to some extent through committee. It still had value from the standpoint of sort of a rallying point, but probably not as much value as it could have if it had kept sort of the original language. And it wasn't written perfectly the first go around anyway. But I think that what it showed is that we can get a jury nullification passed through the state house and probably will, you know, get a better one as things go on.
We got to have more electoral success here first. The Free State Project has already had incredible success here in New Hampshire compared to any other liberty movement across the United States. I would dare say, and someone's welcome to go prove me wrong on this, if you can do all the digging and somehow get this data, but I would say the Free State Project in a decade has had more people elected to public office who are libertarians, voluntarists, anarchists, than the Libertarian Party has had in the entire existence of the Libertarian Party combined in all 50 states.
I would say that that's easily the case.
That's probably pretty accurate, yeah. I mean, I remember libertarians getting super excited that Carla Howe got 12%, and that was like the
in
best thing they ever did. Yeah, I mean...
Yeah. Yep. Also, I do know libertarians have won office as high as the state office because they've won it here in New Hampshire. But if you remove New Hampshire from that the equation, I wonder whether they've got elected anywhere.
They've been elected to like dog catcher,
things like that, yeah.
Water board,
soil and water conservation board, and there's apparently been a couple of city councilors in Texas. 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts on jury nullification. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Getting a good view of a sore throat can be difficult, but the new doctor-recommended sore throat exam kit from SayAhNow.com makes it easy. A first-of-its-kind, scientifically designed oral retractor to relax the tongue, minimize gag reflex, and increase visibility. Our made-in-the-USA kit also includes a medical-grade reference chart, easy-to-use website and app so that you're one click away from unparalleled sore throat information. Click SayAhNow.com. SayAhNow.com, a must-have for your family's medical preparedness.
Now, a twice-as-nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price, $89.95. But now, Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
excuse
you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make
it. Wait, now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us here on the radio waves. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
Tarrin P. Lupo.
And Mark. If you've got a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, unreliable, unpredictable, and late. But it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. RootWork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. They're nerds who know business. They're nerds who know business, and RootWork can make IT meet your needs. And to prove it, they will give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. You're going to get value out of this phone call, and it's a free phone call, simply by going to rootwork.it/FTL. You can go there. You can sign up, get your free call. It's rootwork.it/FTL. It's rootwork.it/FTL.
Let's go to Tom. He's in Baltimore. You're on Free Talk Live. Tom, go ahead.
Hey, guys. I listen to you all the time. I hope there's no rule with calling in. I've called in twice over the years, and I think I've called in three times this week, but you're hitting on topics that I think I can...
The rule is once per day. That's our limit to call-ins. So you're good.
Okay, well, I'm good. You were talking about this guy. Is it in Colorado?
Yeah, a guy in his 50s in Denver was arrested and charged with multiple felonies for handing out information to jurors about jury nullification.
Yeah, I would advise anybody to be real careful with that. You've heard the old expression, permission or apology. When you're dealing with these courts these days, you always want to deal with permission. And that doesn't mean that you have to ask someone and get written permission and tell them exactly what you're going to do, but there are certain ways you can kind of be sneaky and get permission at least to be on the property and make it a little ambiguous. But you run the risk, and even if you're in a large group, of being charged, like you said, with jury tampering or with practicing the law without a license. Now, let me tell you where this comes from. A lot of people, when they're talking about jury nullification, are exactly right in their facts, but they're going way back to citations in law that are from the 1700s. Very hard to find anything relevant in recent years, and there's a reason for that. The courts are switching jurisdictions, and when you're talking to juror members, you may think that you're talking to a seated jury that is a common law jury, when in fact it's an advisory jury. Now, if you don't know the difference between a common law jury,
I can't say I do. I'm sure you can tell me, though.
I'll tell you quick. The common law jury is the one that can nullify the law. They've got more power than anybody in that courtroom. An advisory jury under the jurisdiction of admiralty, or judges are even switching from admiralty to military, the common law, throughout the trials. I've actually seen this happen.
This sounds like a courtroom conspiracy theory.
Well, there's Wikipedia says has an advisory jury right here as a definition. Would you like to hear the definition from Wikipedia before you
cement
your opinion?
Yeah.
Okay. An advisory jury is a group installed by a judge to give him or her an opinion during a trial. Unlike the normal jury, the advisory jury's opinion is non-binding, and the judge remains the final arbiter of fact and law.
Yeah.
Yes, and that's basically what you have in courts. Now, it's not exactly.
But you just said they were switching back and forth during trial. That doesn't make sense.
They're not changing the jury from a common law jury to an advisory one. I'm saying they're switching jurisdiction. In other words, if a lawyer tries to argue a certain point, judges are real slick at moving from one jurisdiction to another. That's probably a whole other conversation. But as
that sounds really strange. I mean, I'm no courtroom expert, but what does it mean to move from one jurisdiction to another? That doesn't even that's something I've never even encountered before.
Well, you can be tried. Ask the next time you go to court whether the court intends to try you under common law.
I've done enough of this kind of stuff, and there's all kinds of people who.
The last time he tried something like that, they threw him in jail.
Yeah, and there's all kinds of people who will call this show and they will advocate, ooh, you ought to do X, Y, and Z in court. And I like to ask them, have you ever tried that?
No, I'm not advising you to do that. I'm just telling you, if you were to ask that in court, I don't think it's a good strategy, by the way. I've actually seen people ask that question and sometimes get an honest answer. Actually, a lot of the judges, they really don't know what they're doing. They're really just steamrolling people a lot of the time.
If the judge doesn't know what they're doing, yes, I agree with you. They're definitely steamrolling people. That much I think we can agree 100% on. But if the judges don't know what they're doing, then how would they be switching jurisdictions at different points throughout the trial? That sounds like deliberate act.
Yes. Well, those judges are in higher courts. They know what they're doing. And I'll tell you, that's when you're in the federal system. Ask yourself, look at the conviction rate. I'll tell you, I've been in federal court before, and I have attorney friends who tell me all the time it's getting more ridiculous. They cannot even advise the jury in a limited way anymore. That's why if you're charged with a federal crime, you might as well take a plea deal
what all the guys in federal prison say. Is that you better take the plea, because if you don't, they're going to throw the book at you and they'll get you the worst possible sentence you can imagine. Tom, what's your experience with courts? You sound like you've done a lot of study. Have you actually spent a lot of time in them?
I'm the rogue cop that called in the other night I spent decades in both the local municipal courts, the state courts, and the federal courts. I was a city police officer and a state special investigator. So I've got experience on the low end, but if you sit back and watch and you spend a lot of time waiting on your case to be called, you pick up on a lot of things that even the attorney sometimes don't pick up on.
Yeah, I got to say, I mean, the fact that you're the cop who called the other night about stopping a trial in the middle of it and just kind of interrupting and talking to the judge— That gave you a lot of credit in my book, and I got to say, I'm more interested now in the idea of this switching jurisdiction simply because it's coming from you. That just on its face sounds like a convoluted mess of a conspiracy theory. So, I'm definitely interested in learning more about that. It doesn't have to be tonight. And Tom, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. It's always interesting to actually hear from people who've spent time in a courtroom.
Yeah, I like when cops call and tell you what's up behind the scenes. Yeah. Now, especially, it's funny, usually they're retired guys,
true.
they're done with it and they'll tell you what really is going down.
Yeah, we've gotten a lot of that over the years here on Free Talk Live, but there's a lot less of people who've called in or fewer people who have called in that have had any real experience in court. There are a lot of people who will get on the radio and say, you ought to try saying this in court the next time you're in there. Oh, yeah? Well, how'd it go for you the last time you tried that? Oh, I never tried it. I've just done a lot of research. Oh, well, how dare you come on the radio and give other people suggestions as to what's going to supposedly work in court when you yourself have no track record whatsoever on actually having it, number one, trying it, and number two, actually getting it to work, because there's like a whole gulf of Mexico in between the two there.
I've heard this stuff for a long time, too. I've been in the movement for almost 20 years, and there's always some sort of magical words that you were talking about you can say in court, and then when you ask someone, it's like the chupacabra or something. People have heard about it. No one's ever seen it. It's always a friend of a friend of a friend who's done it.
Well, there's videos.
Or somebody's tried it. And I have never actually met someone that pulled this stuff off.
I have seen some stuff be done in courtrooms on video. But I'm never left thinking, that's going to work. What I'm left is thinking, oftentimes, the judge has decided that dealing with crazy people is not worth their time and energy, and that they have dismissed this case based on the fact that it is just too annoying to deal with. Now,
yeah,
I'll take
happen.
That. If I'm charged with something, I'm happy to get dismissed because
whatever
I'm annoying.
It takes.
But I just, you know, like I... Things have to work consistently to be considered foolproof methods.
Now, there was something Tom said in there that I really want to talk about because there's something I disagree with. We got distracted into things that we're more in, you know, agreeance on. But the whole idea of getting permission to go and hand things out at court, I think that deserves a better explanation because I totally disagree with Tom on that. But first, let's go to your calls and thoughts. Chris, listening in Florida, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Chris.
Well, Mark Antonelli.
Oh my God, that is way too loud. Okay, Chris, go ahead now. I think you might be better.
Okay, do you read me now?
It's okay. Go ahead, Chris.
Well, Mark Antonelli was jailed by the juror tamperers against whom he was fighting, obviously. And down here we have Mark Schmidter, who was jailed for 141
That's
days.
Who it is, Mark Schmidter. Yeah. Hey, Chris, hang on. I'm going to try to get you on a better phone line. As we continue here, our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. More on jury nullification, which now the state of Colorado is saying is equivalent to jury tampering. This is Free Talk Live. Hour 2's coming up.
Breathe it in, kid. Every 3 months, we install these air handler filters. They're more energy efficient, hold more dust, and are priced to save us more money. And Granger's got close to 3,000 different styles and sizes to choose from, in stock and ready when we need them. I love oxygen, kid. And this facility's got some great AO2. I'm breathing easier just thinking about these air handler filters. Get some today. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com/filters or stop by. Granger. For the ones who get it done.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Hello,
TRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for lrn.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, August 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.97 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,123 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. AntiWar.com reports 75 experts from the Arms Control Association have come out Tuesday with a statement to endorse the P5 plus 1 nuclear deal with Iran, saying the pact was a net plus for nuclear nonproliferation and exceeds historical standards on arms control limitations. The signatories of the statement include several high-profile opponents of the 2003 U.S. invasion of Iraq, including Joe Wilson and Valerie Plame, along with former IAEA chief Hans Blix and former U.S. Ambassador Morty Halperin. The statement goes on to echo the comments of other proponents, saying it would make it easy for the international community to detect any clandestine program by Iran and will decisively prevent Iran from acquiring a nuclear weapon. Congress is planning to vote on the deal on September 17th and is expected to have a majority against the deal. It is not, however, expected to get the veto-proof majority that would be needed to attempt to block U.S. participation in the pact outright.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports Chelsea Manning, the former U.S. Army private serving 35 years in prison for leaking government documents, said she was found guilty on 4 charges of prison misconduct, though she was spared the possible sentence of solitary confinement. Manning tweeted about the results of her hearing with the prison board Tuesday, saying she was found guilty on all 4 charges. Manning was charged with disrespect, disorderly conduct, prohibited property, and medicine misuse by officials of the U.S. disciplinary barracks, the maximum security military prison in Fort Leavenworth, Kansas, where she is serving time for charges including violating the Espionage Act. She wrote, "I was found guilty of all 4 charges at today's board. I'm receiving 21 days of restrictions on recreation, no gym, library, or outdoors." Books and magazines were found in Manning's cell, prompting the charge of prohibited property. Books recovered include I Am Malala by Malala Yousafzai and Hacker, Hoaxer, Whistleblower, Spy, The Many Faces of Anonymous by Gabriella Coleman. Magazines confiscated include the Vanity Fair Call Me Caitlin issue with Caitlyn Jenner on the cover and a Cosmopolitan with an interview of Private Manning. The medicine misuse charge was imposed for an expired tube of toothpaste. Manning said the disciplinary action will likely add years to her sentence when it comes time for parole hearings.
ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports hackers have followed through on a threat to release online a huge cache of data, including customer information that was stolen a month ago from cheating spouse's website, AshleyMadison.com. Several tech websites reported on Tuesday the data was posted on the dark web, meaning it is only accessible using a specialized browser, although vast lists of hundreds of email addresses, including many links to corporations and universities, sprouted up on other sites hours after the news broke. The hackers, who call themselves themselves the impact team, leaked snippets of the compromised data in July, and threatened to publish names and salacious details of as many as 37 million customers unless Ashley Madison and EstablishedMen.com, another site owned by Toronto-based parent company Avid Life Media, were taken down. While other high-profile attacks, such as those on big companies like Sony Pictures Entertainment and Target, have seen credit card data of customers stolen, this attack appeared to confirm that the hackers were not driven by blackmail or commercial motives, but rather ideological. Identifying customers on Ashley Madison, which uses the slogan, "Life is short, have an affair," could have far-reaching consequences for individual people. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to a study released Thursday by the Princeton University Department of Biology, this local two-year-old woodland chipmunk has crafted a far more secure and dependable plan for the future than 8 out of 10 Americans. Reporters spoke to citizens to get their view on the study.
Clearly, this chipmunk is pretty impressive. I mean, he wakes up every morning and says, "I need to collect acorns and berries for the winter." He sets goals for himself and he gets it done.
He has to make a burrow in a tree stump. That's exactly what he does. He doesn't pause and have a snack and lay around for a few hours.
Out of nearly 40 separate interviews with Americans, 33 told reporters they were very impressed by the chipmunk's continued display of foresight, personal responsibility, and pragmatic decision-making when considering his own future.
He's preparing for winter, he's building a home, and he's trying to get enough nutrients to make it throughout the rest of the day. All this while being worried about maybe getting eaten by a wolf or an owl or something. Earlier this week, the electricity went off in my home because I forgot to pay my bill. It's the second time this year.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, and we are sharing with you some not-so-great news out of Denver, Colorado, where one man in his 50s has been arrested. Apparently, this happened a couple of weeks ago, but I didn't know about this until tonight. And thanks to Tarrin Lupo for bringing the story to the forefront here. You can go to TarrinLupo.com and see lots more, Tarrin.
Yes, sir.
Including videos, and we'll be posting one of those and talking about it in a little bit. You can join us here at 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. There's more on what has happened in Colorado with a man being arrested for handing out jury nullification information in front of a Colorado courthouse in Denver. Jury nullification is the age-old right of a juror to vote in a case based on their conscience, based on how you feel about something, not just what the facts of the case are. In fact, the facts of the case could show that the person on the stand, the defense stand, is absolutely guilty by the facts. But if you think that the law itself that they're guilty of is a bad law, you can vote not guilty. That's what jury nullification is about. It's about you exercising your conscience in a case because that matters and it's important. But it's so important, the courts want to stop you from doing it. They want to do everything they possibly can to prevent you from even knowing about jury nullification, which is why they have arrested a man and charged him with multiple felonies for bothering to stand out in front of a Denver courthouse and explain this right to the people that were going in. Let's go right back into your calls and thoughts. We've got Chris, hopefully on a better line here. Chris, are you with us?
Yes, gentlemen, I am.
Sounds much better. You're calling from Florida. You were telling us about the man. Neither Mark nor I could remember his last name, and I should have. Mark Schmidter is his name. He's a similarly aged man in Orlando, Florida, who was also arrested for handing out jury nullification information. Is that right? And are you living in that area?
Well, that's in the Orlando area, Seminole County, and I'm in Clearwater, about 2 hours away. But he continues to do so every Monday.
He's really?
Yes, at the Seminole County Criminal Justice Center in Sanford, Florida. And he did beat the charges after serving 141 days in jail.
He beat the charges?
Yes, he actually beat two different charges. Oh, no, pardon me, he beat another charge. The first time for handing out the FIJA flyers, he served 141 days at the behest of judge, jury, and executioner, Judge Belvin. Let's see here. Judge Belvin Perry,
Belvin Perry,
and you can see on Facebook, his you can see Facebook pages. We are Mark Schmidter, and his personal page, Mark Schmidter, as well as Fully Informed Jury Association of Florida, which is a public group, and FEJA Florida, which is a fan page on Facebook, if you want to check out more details. But, you know, he beat the charge of resisting arrest without violence.
What about the tampering charge? Didn't they hit him with tampering?
Yes, that's what Judge Belvin Perry had convicted him, for which Judge Belvin Perry convicted him.
And was that overturned later, or did he beat that? I mean, did he beat that on appeal, or what's the status on
that? I don't think he did beat. I'm not sure. I don't think he did, though.
But, okay. So he beat the resisting arrest.
Yes, that was
Unfortunately, that's not as important. But I'm interested to know why they haven't arrested him again. That's what's curious to me.
Well, no, that's right. You know, they attempted a free speech zone. The judge did. But what I was just briefly confusing that with was when he was handing out red light camera flyers, and he beat that on a Macon versus the state of Florida case as a precedent, which says basically that you can't be charged with resisting arrest without violence if they have no cause to arrest you in the first place. So that is what he did succeed in beating.
Okay, so he's going to the courthouse. Even though he went to jail for handing out jury nullification flyers, he's still handing them out, which is heroic. But you said he's handing them out in a free speech zone?
No, he's not. He's doing it, as far as I can tell, he's doing it just as the jurors are coming in.
Wow.
And sometimes a few people will join him because he, you know, posts his pictures every Monday of his activism. And,
so what you're saying is, even though they convicted him of jury tampering, he still is at the courthouse and they haven't messed with him a second time?
That's right. I'm not sure, you know, if he did beat it or not. Like I said, I'm just brushing up on this.
I mean, I know he went to jail for it, so if he ended up winning in court, then I sure hope that he filed some sort of lawsuit against them, and maybe that's why they're not messing with him. But otherwise, you know, if they got a conviction, I can't understand why they wouldn't continue to arrest him. I mean, I'm glad they're not, but given the demeanor of this particular judge, he's a very nasty person. It would seem that he would continue to pick on this man for doing that. Anything else you want to share tonight?
Well, it says on the We Are Mark Schmidter page that 141 days in jail for handing out jurors' rights information, which the judge himself has conceded is entirely accurate. The most recent confinement occurred per an arbitrary rule a man wrote, judge denied jury for and sentenced under. The judge, Belvin Perry, yes, the Casey Anthony case judge, acted as legislature, judge, jury, and executioner. By definition, he's acting as a tyrant, and that's a quote from that page. And it should be stated also that if a juror wants to exercise their right as a juror, their right to vote their conscience, that they should not tell their fellow jurors, because then they'll be informed upon. The fellow jurors will inform the prostituting attorney and the judge, and then they'll be dismissed and likely be held in contempt. Instead, a juror voting their conscience should just say that they don't believe the evidence or the witnesses were convincing and leave it at that.
Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I'm flashing back here to an article from 2013, flexyourrights.org, written about Mark Schmidter. He was sentenced to 141 days, and I don't recall if it was an actual jury tampering charge or if he got hit with contempt. Maybe it was contempt that he got, because you don't have to prove contempt, really. There's no criminal trial that you get with a contempt charge. And if you're within the judge's purview, and certainly this judge believes that he is in control of the entire court complex, then I wish I could recall. We'll find out more here in moments. You can share with us your thoughts. 855-450-FREE. Let's go to, I believe we've got Tom on the line. Is this Tom?
Oh, this is Jay.
Oh, hey, Jay. Sorry about that. Jay in Colorado, actually. You're visiting Colorado for a couple years or something like that, right?
That's correct, but I'll be there for Keenvention.
Oh, awesome. All right,
oh, it'll be good to see you.
Yeah, and it'd be good to see you guys. I missed you. Anyways, Yeah, I got charged with jury tampering twice.
Really?
2001 and 2003. And in 2004, a very good friend of mine actually got arrested for it. I wasn't arrested. A summons showed up in the mail. And I thought it was great because my thought was, hey, guess what evidence the jury gets to see? This paperwork that I was passing out in the courthouse, because I would go to court just with my friends all the time, and I've been to court a lot, and we'd bring these little citizen rule books
yep.
that had jury nullification stuff and the Constitution and talked about Communist Manifesto and all that. And we bought thousands of them years ago. My dad was big time. My dad would drop like $300 at a time in like the 90s on these things. And he passed them out all over the place. Anyways, so I basically said to the prosecutor on the first time I went there, they called my name and went up there and they said, all right, go talk to the prosecutor. So I go talk to the prosecutor. They go, hey, this is pretty cool. I go, the jury's actually going to be able to get to see the jury.
Because it's evidence in the case. I love it. That's a great point. And they wait. So did they actually take you to trial, or do they end up dropping the charges right beforehand so they could
So he goes, I can plead or whatever. So they dropped it. The first one, I never even talked to a judge or nothing. We went back in the courtroom, sat down. They called a bunch of people, and then they just called my name and said, your case is dismissed.
Uh-huh. Yep. Thanks, Jay Noon. How appreciate it, man. More coming up here. This is Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
Molly's been having 4 scoops a day, and she has slimmed down and gotten this puppy look. Her coat has sheen. You can't believe it.
Oh, yeah.
Her breath is better. She's just perkier. It's just so totally amazing. She's a gorgeous Springer Spaniel. She's 12 and a half years old. The last 2-3 years, she was really becoming very old, very slow, was very sad.
I thought, oh, this is it.
I was driving along one day, and I heard this person raving about Dynovite. Dynovite.com. Dynovite.com.
859-428-1000.
She's got life. She's got energy. She's got stuff to give.
She loves it. She chomps at every last single crumb.
These ingredients are natural. The flax in the yeast cultures in the grains.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
We're on our third order now. We just want everybody to know about Dynovite.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Dynovite.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MYTV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
This message is for home intruders, the cowards who break into people's homes to steal their hard-earned property, criminals who shatter lives and rob people of their privacy and security. Listen very carefully. We're the home security experts at LiveWatch, and we're taking you down. Because we're letting everyone try our newest home security system for one full year in their home. To take advantage of this amazing offer, call now, 1-800-670-9259. LiveWatch has been helping protect homes for years, and we've learned the secrets that intruders like you don't want people to know. Criminals, it's time for you to be afraid, because every person who calls will be protected against cowards like you. To the criminals listening, we're taking you down. To those who want to help protect their homes, call the security experts to try the LiveWatch security system. There are no long-term contracts, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can cancel at any time. Try LiveWatch now by calling 1-800-670-9259. That's 1-800-670-9259.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
It is Free Talk Live. You are invited to join us here. The toll-free number for you to take control of the airwaves, 855-450-FREE. It doesn't have to be about jury nullification. That is, though, the thrust of the show thus far, talking about a man in Colorado arrested, charged with multiple felony counts of jury tampering because he gave out information about your rights as a juror. It's called jury nullification. You can go and learn more over at the Fully Informed Jury Association. FIJA.org is their website, FIJA.org, and we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts here in a moment. Also want you to know about Purse. In fact, you can, I believe, now go to a new URL, Mark. We've got a fancy new URL. It's called saveatpurse.com.
That's right. The idea is to bring people in that might not, you know, be necessarily hardcore listeners of Free Talk Live by having a website that's easier for them to remember. Saveatpurse.com.
Yeah, that's super easy. I got to credit you. I think you came up completely with that one.
Yeah, well, I mean, hopefully if you have on board a marketing genius, they can they can do something every once in a while.
So saveatpurse.com is the same as purse.freetalklive.com. So we've been saying purse.freetalklive.com a lot. You're certainly welcome to continue using that. That will stay active.
It is the same thing.
Saveatpurse.com takes you to the same URL, which is our affiliate link over on Purse. And that's because we get a very small portion of whatever you purchase once you create your account through Purse, which you can go to saveatpurse.com to do that. Now, here's the trick. You can save 20% on Amazon on anything, even more than 20% on almost anything on Amazon. You just have to use Bitcoin to make the purchase. Now, some people have been getting very creative with this. I saw a headline today, an article about someone who figured out a way to get 25% off gasoline by using Purse, by using saveatpurse.com.
Really? How so?
All right, so here's what they did. They went to Amazon, they put into their cart gift cards for GameStop, and they purchased games. Now, why this is, I don't know, but apparently with a GameStop gift card, you can then purchase Shell gift cards for Shell gas stations.
All right.
So this person has been getting 25% off of their gasoline by buying their GameStop.
That's another thing on the list that Amazon doesn't sell. Gasoline.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
so
true.
It's not everything you need for life.
That's pretty brilliant.
It's everything you need for life but produce and gasoline.
If you're willing to jump through the hoops, you can get a huge discount on every fill up of gasoline. That's incredible.
I've gotten over 20% on just about everything I've done.
It's easy.
Yeah. I'm still got one thing I'm holding out on. I put it 30 that no one's bought. Still waiting on my flugelhorn.
The average is 20%.
Well, the things that you might not want as much,
yeah,
right?
Like I got time on that.
Exactly.
It's just a horn I want that I can normally not afford.
You can wait.
You can
afford to wait. So go and get started. Saveatpurse.com, and we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. I do still want to talk about getting permission to go and hand out flyers at a courthouse. There was a caller earlier who's with the police, who suggested that that should be done, and I firmly disagree. But first, Dave is in Poughkeepsie, New York. You're on Free Talk Live. Dave.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Hello, sir. You're on the air.
I do not like Gina London at all.
Who?
I don't know who that is. Why does this person matter?
All right. Do you remember a while back ago when Bob and a Black Dude from X Transmission FM called in about me, and I never got a chance to rebuttal back? I want to rebuttal back tonight.
Now, wait, are those two different people, Gina and Bob?
Gina and Bob and the Black Boots, they're both like a DJs or whatever over at xtransmissionfm.com.
Uh-huh. Are you sure they didn't hire you to promote their show on our show, and that this is just?
I am pretty sure.
Put
I am
on.
Pretty sure of it.
You're just an agent
sure
of Gina and Bob's.
Anyway,
you're doing their bidding.
Anyway, listen.
You're sure about that?
Listen to what I have to say.
Uh huh.
They blocked me from listening to their station as of Monday.
Wow.
Night.
Blocked you as a listener. Does that mean that you can't talk? Is that the idea? Like they can't block you from listening and block you
are
from
you
talking
prevented?
And have to do one or the other?
Yeah, I want to know if Mark, are you actually prevented from listening or are you prevented from calling them?
No, X Transmission FM is a radio station. It's not a call-in radio show like your guy's show is.
Yeah.
It's a listen. You can just he does a show like every Monday night, like something.
It's a music show, right?
Yes.
He's playing
and,
rock
you know,
music.
Rock, metal, goth, yeah, whatever.
No one's
I can
doing
no longer
that on the
listen
radio.
To their. I can no longer yet because I do not like Gina and I do not like Bob and the Black Boots.
You didn't answer my question though, Dave. Dave. You did not answer the question. The question is, have you actually been prohibited from listening to the FM station that you're referencing?
Yes, I have.
So when you actually go and try to click to listen to the rock music, it gives you some kind of error?
Yes, it does. I can't listen to Winamp through their website.
That is really interesting because they must have banned your IP address from being able to interact with their server. That's like the most extreme method of cutting somebody off. I mean, because I don't care if the trolls listen to Free Talk Live. I mean, that doesn't bother me. Please, you know,
heck,
listen,
you let them call in.
Listen to our show. You can certainly call in about anything you want to. Well, I don't know if Dave's a troll.
Some of them live in Poughkeepsie.
I mean, don't you have to be, in order to be a troll, don't you have to intentionally be a troll? I guess you could be an unintentional troll.
I'm not a troll. I'm not a troll because, like, you know, because Bob and the Black Boots.
No, you're just mean. I mean, you're just you're being nice to us, kind of. But
I want to get a chance to rebuttal back.
What do you want to say?
Bob and the Black Boots was very, very wrong about me, and I do not like Gina at all.
It's not a rebuttal. It's not a rebuttal to call to.
He was wrong because.
Yeah.
I even bashed her name all over Craigslist rants and raves. Yeah.
I don't like Gina because.
Because she blocked me. You know, she blocked
because
me.
Because she blocked me.
Why did she block you?
Gee, I can't imagine.
Why did
because
she block you?
Because
she's
such a wet douche.
That's
why.
She's no. a wet douche. Okay.
Is that an ad hominem? She blocked me because she's a wet douche.
Thanks for the call,
that's
Dave.
That makes a lot
that's
of
enough.
Sense.
That's enough of that. Was that your first time hearing Dave?
He called last Wednesday,
okay.
But this is this is fun. I just love that you just let him roll, and it's no problem. Like there's some sort of personal beef on some obscure podcast that like the listening public would know what this is.
This is not a beef.
It's not even a podcast.
It's a
stream.
It's a stream.
He's mad because they won't play his request.
He calls him like this all of the time. he's done it for years.
Wait.
He's always somebody out there.
I kind of like him. I'm sorry.
He's made angry because he doesn't understand that you can't cuss at people. You can't belittle them. You can't call them names. You can't treat them like crap and then expect them to treat you nice. He just doesn't get it. 100% doesn't get it.
And then you're right. And then he wonders why they would cut him off, why they would refuse to talk to him, why they would ban him from their Twitter pages. And he feels like it's a conspiracy against him. In fact, that was the reason why he called our show 2 years ago, over how long it's been now.
Right.
And
somebody
was
he had another beef with some other show.
He's always complaining.
He was on the Craigslist forum. Apparently, there's some place you can go and talk to people on Craigslist. Who knew? There's a Craigslist forum. He was on there, and people were calling him a pedophile and claiming he was on welfare. And he gets some kind of assistance of some sort or another that I'm not entirely sure of. But, you know, like whatever they were saying about him, he was just upset about it. And so he calls in to tell us.
Yeah, and then he proceeds to go on the Free Talk Live BBS.
He's also threatened us more than one time, too.
Yeah, and then he's gone on the Free Talk Live BBS and has been super annoying there
to the point where he gets banned. In action.
He gets banned by the admins over there on multiple accounts. This is Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. Call about anything.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free to join us here on the radio, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Jury nullification. Outreach activist in Denver has been arrested, charged with felony counts, multiple felonies of jury tampering, because seven jurors apparently talked to him, so now he's facing seven felony counts. Which, of course, could wind him up in prison for, I imagine, quite a while. Usually minimum time on felonies is 3 years, so I'm not sure
what exactly he's facing here, but it's nothing small.
It blows me away. It's a felony, like the same as you get for shooting someone.
It's probably not the same class of felony. It's probably not the same, you know, level of it. Not as serious.
Doesn't felony mean that you can't own a gun, you can't vote, you
can't... That's exactly what that means.
I mean, it just strips you of a bunch of rights.
Yeah, it's definitely a serious charge. I'm not trying to take away how serious it is. It is serious, just probably not quite as much of a felony as a murder, but nonetheless, still in the same category. We're going to continue. You can share your thoughts. Bob is listening in Columbus, Ohio. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Bob.
How are you guys doing tonight?
What's on your mind, Bob?
Well, I just heard the call from Dave from Poughkeepsie again, and once again he smeared not only my name but the name of my radio station all over, and once again I would like to set the record straight.
So, what are the odds that you are listening? I really appreciate you tuning into the show. How did you end up figuring out that Dave was calling Free Talk Live to talk about you in the first place?
He bragged about it on Twitter.
That sounds like him.
So you're
like,
you're following him on Twitter.
actually, I blocked him, but after certain events today, I unblocked him and started following him again.
What did he do today?
Okay, well, he was talking about the station owner, Gina, and how he got on Craigslist and basically tried to smear her name on Craigslist. Well, he also added her personal information, her phone number, and her address.
So he's been creeping.
Yeah, he is cyber-stalking, and we are looking into legal action.
Well, you know, I don't know if it's illegal to reveal someone's, let's just say he looked her up in the white pages, right? I don't know how he got the info. I haven't seen it. I don't know how legit it is. But let's presume it's legit and it was just publicly available in the white pages.
If Dave did it, it couldn't be too complicated.
Yeah. If it's you know, if it's publicly available information, you probably don't really have a leg to stand on legally.
This is not legal advice.
Yeah, I'm not.
There's
I'm not
some
an
lawyer
attorney.
Out there that would be happy to take your money.
There certainly it will be. Whether or not you'll prevail in court, or whether or not it's really even worth your while to prevail or pay any attention whatsoever to Dave, is another question for you to decide. I, you know, we take his calls here because it's an open phone show and he's relatively crazy and entertaining. So, you know, we put him on the air.
He kind of has some fans.
But he, you know, he has also at some point basically threatened Mark and I think to a lesser extent myself. So there is that. And I can understand the concern about that. That's certainly a legitimate concern when it comes to Dave. Who knows how sane he is? Is he sane enough to not actually commit an act of violence? I don't know about that.
Well, it's like I said, we're just speaking. We're just basically seeing what we can do about it because honestly, we just want this guy to leave us alone. I mean,
that's what you get for playing the rock hits, buddy.
The devil's music.
Understood. And we have nothing personal against this individual. It's just every time we let him in the chat, he finds a way to insult or threaten somebody.
He's not allowed on. He's only allowed on Free Talk Live, the show. He's not allowed.
That
to
way
be
we have complete control over it. He's not. He's blocked from the chat room. Yeah, blocked from the BBS.
Right, he can't get into those places, and that's because he's completely antisocial. And at the same time, he blames everybody else. All right, hey Bob, plug your website for people that want to go listen to the rock and roll. We'll give you
okay. It's xtransmissionfm.com. And one thing I would like to say is I really wanted to settle this peacefully and amicably, but that just proved impossible. So
yeah, I imagine it's pretty hard to reason with Dave. I mean, it's hard enough to have a 2-minute long conversation with him without him repeating himself over and over again, let alone to try to instill in him some sense of value for himself or what it is he's doing in life and the things he's trying to accomplish. I mean, we've tried over the years to give Dave a little bit of help from far away, and boy, it just doesn't stick. At one point, we had to ban him from the air. I mean, we've never done that to anybody on Free Talk Live, but we had to ban him from the radio because he just kept calling about the same thing over and over again. Bob, good luck. Thanks for your call tonight. He just kept calling in about the same exact topic, and you know, there aren't a lot of rules on Free Talk Live. One of the rules is you can call once per day. And sort of the unspoken rule is you should make those calls different. You shouldn't call and say the same thing each time you call in. That gets really old
really fast.
Yeah.
And
even if everybody who's listening now isn't listening every time you call in, I'm sitting here and I have to listen to you say the same thing over and over again.
Especially when it's like some personal beef that maybe two people know about on the planet.
Right. I love the dude called back in right after Dave.
That's why I suspect that Dave was actually hired by Bob to promote his rock radio station.
Ingenious. I don't think Dave's got it in him to act, though. I really...
You think he's for real, huh?
Oh, I think he's...
He sounded pretty legit. I think the guy's just getting harassed.
Sadly and insufferably for real.
I think he's real, too. I really do. He's got too many crazy videos on the internet to be fake. You said you really like Dave, Tarrin. You should check out his YouTube channels.
I don't want any attention from him.
No, you can watch his YouTube without getting attention from him. He doesn't have... I mean, he already hears your name, so if he wants to give you attention, he certainly can. But, you know, if you go on his YouTube, what is it, Hudson Valley Guy and the number one?
I think it's
been a while since I've been on there. He called in once and actually threatened to take his YouTube channel off the air, and I'm so glad he didn't, because it is... A lot of it is super entertaining, and you really ought to watch. The thing is, you don't ever have to watch the whole video, because Dave repeats himself over and over again. So really, all you have to watch is like the first 30 or maybe 30 seconds to a minute of the video, and you'll pretty much get the gist of it.
So all these beef things that he you know, every once in a while he'll call on Free Talk Live and do, he hits YouTube with them. And so he goes on.
Yeah, he records the show.
And he will do, no, he'll record the show, but he'll be like, he'll do these beefs against people. He'll say, Ian, I'm going to, you make me so mad. And he'll put on glasses, and he does this sort of Macho Man Savage thing. And he talks in this gruff, gravelly voice to be a little extra scary. And he'll cuss at you and do a variety of things. So over time.
I am not a leech.
I am not on welfare. I am not a pedophile. And he'll just do it over and over again.
It's true. Let's go to Jimmy. He's in Vegas. Jimmy, you're on Free Talk Live. Hey, you're on the air.
Hey, I just want to say, Dave, this guy's an absolute moron. He just ruins my time listening to your show.
Aw.
Stop playing this guy, please.
Stop playing him. Well, we can't really do that. I mean, it's an open phone show. If we show favoritism towards you, Jimmy, then that...
Well, tell you what, Jimmy, if we have... We'll always take him last as far as callers go. How's that?
That's true. He generally doesn't...
I'm not trying to say favoritism. Okay. I don't want any favoritism. He ruins my enjoyment of the show. There's actual topics, like intellectual topics you guys could talk about, and this guy's...
It takes all sorts.
We usually only have him on for a minute or something like that. I mean, you know, if he derails, normally he doesn't derail the show in that we talk about him, but it's been kind of funny and the dude called in afterwards.
See, the thing is, Jimmy, and I appreciate the feedback, but it's hard to get feedback like that because on the other hand, there are people who love it when Dave calls in, right? Like they probably want to hear more interactions of Free Talk Live with Dave. And so you can't make everybody happy, I guess. And
yes, I mean, sometimes the show's just not going to be intellectual. You know, we're going to have some stupid fun on here.
It does happen. It doesn't happen as often.
Those are some of the greatest shows ever, though.
I tend to agree. It's true. Jimmy, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it, man. Appreciate hearing from you tonight. Oh, I don't know what you're going to say there. Shotgun? Shout out? Anyway.
Shut your mouth, you skinny little twerp.
Shake his fist at you.
So, yeah, it's an open phone show, so you can join us here, 855-450-FREE. We don't care what your viewpoint is. We don't care if you've got an intellectual thing to say. We can handle the dumb stuff. 855-450-FREE. I like character callers and creative calls as well.
We used to get a lot of character calls.
It doesn't have to be, you know, all issues all the time. It's open phones. It's Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE allows you to join us about what you want. So take control of the airwaves. It's Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS80, Guns80.com.
In recent years, we have witnessed the most catastrophic disasters in history. Earthquakes, hurricanes, tornadoes, typhoons, and more. Legacy Premium Food Storage will prepare you. Our great-tasting, non-GMO quality food products have a 25-year shelf life, are the most affordable on the market, and are American-made. They're perfect for hiking, camping, and road trips, too. Be prepared with the best. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. That's SurvivalFoodAlliance.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallow Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. Keenevention.info. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us on the radio here at 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype. Skype username tonight for you is 855... No, it's not. It's lrn.fm. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. With you tonight in studio, Ian here.
And Tarrin P. Lupo.
And Mark.
Tarrin is here, courtesy of his website, tarrinlupo.com. We have put up on our Facebook and Twitter a link to your most recent video, Tarrin, or one of your most recent videos, about alpacas.
Yeah, they just came out yesterday. And
what is an alpaca?
An alpaca is kind of like a camel or a llama. It's a South American animal that a lot of people, when I requested what should my next video about, I got a flood of people that wanted to know about alpacas. And apparently,
are there alpacas in New Hampshire?
There's a huge alpaca farm right up the street in Greenfield.
No kidding.
Yeah, it's one of the biggest around on the East Coast. So
how do you have South American camels?
What happened in the 90s is that there was this big craze where people were making tons of money importing these things, and they were breeding them and selling them to other people who thought they could breed them. And you make money on the fleece, too. You can shave them like a sheep.
Okay.
So they were kind of people that bought in this craze, and then it got so out of hand that they just stopped, they closed the borders to shipping them in. So all the ones that were here are here, and they were kind of overbred, and all these people tried farming them and failed really badly. So after 10, 20 years, you know, it's like the leftovers. And so there's some people that are very successful with alpacas, and there's others who aren't. And some really weird things. They're really weird, Ian. They have they're fun, though. So when they want to mate, the male sings to the female and hypnotizes her until she drops and lets him mate. So I mean, I tried the technique with my girlfriend. It didn't work. But other than that, it's called orgling, where you sing to them. And there's just a bunch of really weird stuff. If you love cute alpacas, go watch the video. But they're strange.
Or if you've never heard of them, go watch the video.
Apparently, they're very popular. So there you go. And they're in New Hampshire.
Yeah, I don't know how successful the singing thing is, but if you do the dishes, it helps.
You should try to orgle.
Let's go to the phones here, to the phone. We've got Akko. He is on the line calling from not Cameroon, where he normally is calling for us from. He's in Nigeria tonight. Akko, welcome to Free Talk Live.
Hello, Ian. Hello, Mark. Hello, Tarrin. Happy to be back on the show.
Yeah, welcome back. What brings you, what is it, about 12 hours? I'm looking at Google Maps here between where you are in Nigeria and Abuja, I guess, Abuja, Nigeria, and your home?
Yes, I am in Abuja, in the capital of Nigeria. I flew into Abuja from Douala.
And Douala is in Cameroon. What was the reason for the trip?
Okay, I had an appointment at the Polish embassy for my visa because Kamil Sebuski, a fellow libertarian from Poland, who is the proprietor of Asbiro Foundation and Asbiro University, invited me there for a conference on free market system and entrepreneurship. So I applied for the visa. So they gave me the program, the appointment date yesterday. So he paid my flight. I flew in to Abuja to attend the interview.
Wow. So you
for
actually
the Polish interview.
Right. So the Polish embassy, they don't have one in Cameroon. You had to actually go to Nigeria for that?
No, we don't have the Polish embassy in Cameroon. You have to come to the nearest one, which is here in Abuja.
What's it like crossing the border from Cameroon into... Oh, wait, you were flying. So what was the security like getting from one place to another?
No, the security is very tight due to this issue of Boko Haram. Mm. So you have to pass through various checkpoints, security. You must travel with your passport and other travel documents. If not, you will not pass through the security.
And you made it through. You didn't have to pay any bribes?
No. This time around, it didn't have to be like that.
How do you know? I mean, when
how do you know when they want a bribe?
Yeah, how would they let you know that? Because here in the United States, it would be a very strange conversation. I would be very surprised, and it would that if a government official was wanting a bribe.
No, this was the best trip of my life because I boarded a plane for the first time from Douala, Addis Abeba in Ethiopia, and then from Ethiopia we came straight to Abuja. It was just easy going because I had all my documents in place.
So it made it easy for you to, you had the paperwork, you got through the checkpoints. You went to the interview. What was that like? Anything you want to share from going to the embassy?
Yes. They asked me various questions about the reason why I wanted to go to Poland. I explained to them, and they asked me about the conference and what I was going to present there. So they told me that I should come back on Thursday at 2 p.m. So I am waiting. I don't know what is going to be the outcome of the interview.
So the idea, I've never done this before, Mark. You've done some international travel. You get one of these visas. You have to actually, to get one of these visas, in some cases, have to go to the nearest embassy.
Well, I've never gone to a place where I have to get a visa.
Really? Okay.
The U.S. passport is a
I have.
You have? Okay.
Yeah, I just went to Burma last year, and you either have to go to the embassy or you can kind of like pay someone to handle it for you.
Like an agent?
Yeah, an agent will get you a stamp and your visa.
Because it might be if you're in New Hampshire, the embassy's in New York City or something like that. How far away was the embassy?
D.C. Everything's in D.C.
Oh, really?
Pretty much, yeah. You can. My brother lived in D.C. and just sent the paperwork in and took care of it. But you don't actually have to show up sometimes, but I think you have to pay more if you don't. So it's
what
just
did it cost
tax.
To get the visa for Burma?
I think it was around $80.
So are you going to have to pay as well? Or you said the gentleman from Poland, Kamil, is going to be paying your way, Akko?
No, he has paid for everything.
Oh,
the flight, the hotel reservation, medical insurance, everything.
It's incredible. What an incredibly generous thing. For our listeners who don't know, Akko has called us now for, over a year? When was the first time you called Free Talk Live? Do you recall that?
That was July 2014,
yes.
Last year.
So well over a year since you first called the show from Cameroon and explaining that you're listening to us on our satellite radio channel that broadcasts to a large swath of West, East, Central Africa. We, at one point, or several points, you'd called in and, talked about life in Cameroon and, people are listening all around the world. And so one of our listeners and supporters who is putting together this conference that you mentioned earlier in Poland invited you, Akko, to come and speak at this. And this has been an amazing experience for you because you've never really had a reason to do or could afford this kind of international traveling. And what a, generous...
Ian, this is the most amazing experience of my life. I never knew that I would get to this level. It is just like dream come true. And I just hope that tomorrow when I will go to the embassy, they will give me the visa. Then I will attend the conference and do a wonderful presentation there.
I think that's
the way. I know you will.
Yeah, I think that's the way it'll work out. I sure hope so. And I got my fingers crossed for you. Akko, anything else you want to share with our listeners tonight?
Yes, I want to say thank you to Kamil Sebuski from Poland. He is a very generous person. He has been treating me like a son to him. Thank you very much. I am very grateful.
And how long is that passport good for? You did get a Cameroon passport. So how long do they, normally there's an expiration date. In theory, you could use it again at some other point.
Yes, it will expire in 2020.
Okay.
The expiration here is 5 years. Yes.
That's not bad.
Now, I know you've got some bitcoins have been donated to you. You'll probably be able to spend them when you get to Poland, huh?
Yes, maybe when I get to Poland, I will be able to spend it there. But I just pray that tomorrow I get that visa.
You got to keep it short term. That's for sure. Keep your short term goals in sight. Akko, great call as always. You sound good. And thank you for the call from Nigeria tonight as we continue. You're welcome to join us here. 855-450-FREE. The outpouring of support Akko has received from Free Talk Live listeners has been fantastic.
That's
it really
a cool
has.
Cat. I've heard of, a call once or twice before, but how did he find this show in Africa?
On satellite. So here's a slightly longer version of that story. We're on satellite in North and Central America. We've been on satellite there since 2010. In 2012, the satellite company came to me as a customer of theirs and said, hey, we've got this extra satellite that we just launched or was just launched. We've got space on it. We want to put you on for free as just a gratis trial period. It was supposed to be a 2-month-long trial. It ended up being more than 2 years that we were on that particular satellite for no charge. Normally it's
remember, it's hard to make money advertising to Central Africa, so not as many companies are going to do it. Obviously, the Christian broadcasters are going to do it because they're trying to save souls. But
I never thought about that. That's probably pretty tough to advertise there, especially when you can't easily get money out of the country to buy
stuff.
On Amazon and order.
We're not doing it for advertising purposes. We're just doing it for spreading liberty purposes. But he found us there on that satellite because people in very poor countries tend to like these free-to-air satellites because there's free television and free radio up there, and they don't have to pay a subscription fee. So that's the short version. He found us on the satellite and then called in, and now he's traveling the world. More coming up.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Geico applauds your inner road name.
A slow clap goes out to your biker alter ego. You might be mild-mannered Michael in the office, the guy known for raising his hand in meetings, but out on the open road, it's Motor Mike. Geico supports you and your bike, Motor Mike, because beyond cars, Geico insures motorcycles, those glorious vroom vroom machines. With 24/7 customer service and great rates, the only thing you'll be raising from now on is a heck of a good time. So head out on the highway and make that road yours, Mike. Make it yours.
Geico Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is up $10 at $1,128 per ounce. Silver is 36 cents higher at $15.30 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $232. Not writing Bitcoin down on the block size controversy doesn't mean you don't like Bitcoin. Use it to buy silver and swap back at the bottom. Call us at 800-874-9760 or online at rrbi.co.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keenan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, August 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.97 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,123 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. Antiwar.com reports 75 experts from the Arms Control Association have come out Tuesday with a statement to endorse the P5+1 nuclear deal with Iran, saying the pact was a net plus for nuclear nonproliferation and exceeds historical standards on arms control limitations. The signatories of the statement include several high-profile opponents of the 2003 U.S. invasion of Iraq, including Joe Wilson and Valerie Plame, along with former IAEA chief Hans Blix and former U.S. Ambassador Morty Halperin. The statement goes on to echo the comments of other proponents, saying it would make it easy for the international community to detect any clandestine program by Iran and will decisively prevent Iran from acquiring a nuclear weapon. Congress is planning to vote on the deal on September 17th and is expected to have a majority against the deal. It is not, however, expected to get the veto-proof majority that would be needed to attempt to block U.S. participation in the pact outright.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports Chelsea Manning, the former U.S. Army private serving 35 years in prison for leaking government documents, said she was found guilty on 4 charges of prison misconduct, though she was spared the possible sentence of solitary confinement. Manning tweeted about the results of her hearing with the prison board Tuesday, saying she was found guilty on all 4 charges. Manning was charged with disrespect, disorderly conduct, prohibited property, and medicine misuse by officials of the U.S. disciplinary barracks, the maximum security military prison in Fort Leavenworth, Kansas, where she is serving time for charges including violating the Espionage Act. She wrote, "I was found guilty of all 4 charges at today's board. I'm receiving 21 days of restrictions on recreation, no gym, library, or outdoors. Books and magazines were found in Manning's cell, prompting the charge of prohibited property. Books recovered include I Am Malala by Malala Yousafzai and Hacker, Hoaxer, Whistleblower, Spy, The Many Faces of Anonymous by Gabriella Coleman. Magazines confiscated include the Vanity Fair Call Me Caitlin issue with Caitlyn Jenner on the cover and a Cosmopolitan with an interview of Private Manning. The medicine misuse charge was imposed for an expired tube of toothpaste. Manning said the disciplinary action will likely add years to her sentence when it comes time for parole hearings. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports hackers have followed through on a threat to release online a huge cache of data, including customer information that was stolen a month ago from cheating spouse's website, AshleyMadison.com. Several tech websites reported on Tuesday the data was posted on the dark web, meaning it is only accessible using a specialized browser, although vast lists of hundreds of email addresses, including many links to corporations and universities, sprouted up on other sites hours after the news broke. The hackers, who call themselves the Impact Team, leaked snippets of the compromised data in July and threatened to publish names and salacious details of as many as 37 million customers unless Ashley Madison and EstablishedMen.com, another site owned by Toronto-based parent company Avid Life Media, were taken down. While other high-profile attacks, such as those on big companies like Sony Pictures Entertainment and Target, have seen credit card data of customers stolen, this attack appeared to confirm that the hackers were not driven by blackmail or commercial motives, but rather ideological. Identifying customers on Ashley Madison, which uses the slogan, "Life is short, have an affair," could have far-reaching consequences for individual people. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Following today's press conference in which NASA announced its continuing search for a planet capable of supporting NASA, researcher Dr. Kenneth Heiser sat down with Onion reporters to detail their ongoing mission to find a NASA-habitable planet.
Our objective is to find a planet capable of nurturing not just life, but also a sustained interest in the exploration of the cosmos. Such a planet would need to have water and proximity to light and heat, but also life forms with even the vaguest understanding of the importance of astronomical exploration. Ultimately, this would need to be a planet with organisms that have a genuine interest in expanding the limits of their knowledge.
Heiser added that any planet capable of supporting NASA would need to be able to generate a steady stream of financing to meet the agency's $18 billion annual budget.
The important thing is we just need to be patient. There's a limitless number of planets in the universe, and eventually we'll find one with the resources to support our work. We just have to, right?
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can join us here. We've been discussing a lot about jury nullification. There's more to say. A man has been arrested and charged with felonies, not in New Hampshire, by the way. This is happening in Colorado. In New Hampshire, we've actually got jury outreach that is very similar to what this man was doing in Denver. And here it is happening in an unmolested manner. There are people in New Hampshire, Free State Project participants and New Hampshire natives alike, who are going out and sharing this same information that this man was arrested for in Denver about your right as a juror to vote your conscience.
I hear there's some things that you can smoke right in Denver that here in New Hampshire you go to jail for.
That's like, true.
Yeah, different jurisdictions have different rules.
I don't get that. People are always about Colorado, and you know, because they you can smoke pot there, so they're all excited and they think it's this bastion of liberty now.
It's ridiculous.
And it's like the one thing they have. Everything else,
you can go smoke pot in Alaska now. Yeah, you can smoke pot in Oregon now. You can smoke pot in California. I mean, look, it's not hard to get a medical license in California. Okay, so
I'm just saying, I don't understand how this thing's sold as a bastion of freedom.
But no, you're right. There are certain people in the liberty movement who are all about Colorado. And from what I understand, there are a lot of gun restrictions in Colorado. In fact, there's also the Mercatus Center, which certainly, if you're going to choose between Colorado and, let's say, California— the choice is pretty easy, right? One of them is...
If you're basing it on liberty, I mean, if you're basing it on a job or a love interest, which is the main reason why most people move.
Yeah.
The Mercatus Center has the freedom of the 50 states, and Colorado's ranked at number 19. So it's mid-pack. I mean, it's in the top half of states. It's not as bad as California, which is number 49. So, you know, given the choice, if you're going to go smoke some pot somewhere, Colorado is probably one of the better places to go and do that. In fact,
what are the top five these days?
Top five? New Hampshire is at number four. You got North Dakota at number one, South Dakota at number two, and Tennessee at number three, interestingly. Oklahoma
Tennessee has a very high corruption rating, but not on this this particular
Oklahoma at number five. Now, New Hampshire, hopefully we'll see it climbing up the charts here as more liberty-loving people make the move here. In fact, hasn't it been as high as number one or two on this list?
No, it's been number one twice and likely to be a third time, as I understand it. I have been checking with one of the authors.
Cycling up. It's probably because there was some more exciting news, you know, around the country with the pot laws and, it's coming up. But I would imagine that New Hampshire is going to pull ahead. I can't imagine it wouldn't.
One of the authors happened to know what his sort of take on it is, and he believes that New Hampshire has improved. Now, he doesn't get to do all the ratings.
Right. The other states could also have improved as well.
No, so he rates all the states. He doesn't rate everything in every state, if that makes sense. He rates the same things in all the states.
I'd prefer not to speculate on what the next version of this is.
I'm not speculating. I'm repeating.
I'm sorry, I was, but I was having fun.
Yeah. We'll find out. And when it does come out, we will certainly let you know as to what the latest freedom rankings are. But yeah, there's definitely an issue with people promoting Colorado as some sort of liberty bastion. And I'm sorry, I just don't see it. I don't see it at all.
I don't get it either.
You can't even smoke the pot outside.
Come on.
You can't even smoke. I mean, yeah, you can smoke pot, but you can't.
People are smoking outside there.
Are they? I've heard there are a lot of arrests for that.
Well, there were parties where it was going on, and they let things go. I'm not suggesting
parties on private property are probably a little different from being walking down the street smoking a joint.
I certainly don't know all the specifics.
I've heard that the police have drastically increased the number of outdoor smoking arrests because of this.
I wonder if there's fines involved. They probably are. I don't have
any
idea.
I suspect there are. In fact, that's why they're cracking down on this, because it's another way for them to make some revenue.
You can't drink alcohol in New Hampshire either. So
in most places, they have open container restrictions, I'm pretty sure. Savannah was one of the exceptions to that rule, wasn't it?
Yeah, rare. That was one of the only places I've ever lived that you could walk around with a beer, but that's because they
How many times did you exercise that, right?
All the time in college. You know, we used to drive down there for a rugby tournament, and they had this huge rugby thing where on St. Paddy's Day, the place goes nuts. So it was a lot of fun. You could drink their open container because they made so much money on tourism and drinking.
I think
it's a drinking town.
I mean, so what? People are going to be drunk on the streets anyway. Why shouldn't they be able to have a beer in their hand?
Yeah, basically what they finally decided was, like, if you pour it in a cup and we don't see it in a bottle, it's fine. You know,
so there wasn't no bottles rule?
They after a while, I think they did, because people were breaking the glass everywhere.
Yeah, that's no good. You can't have that.
I can see that one.
So they put it in cups and...
We can't have a voluntarist society because glass might be broken on sidewalks. There you go.
You can have private property, Mark, where people have rules about what is allowed and what is not.
They did get a little mad about the public urination. We had some experiences with that.
That happens anyway, though.
But
if people are drinking at bars home.
All right, so it's like a Mardi Gras situation where you're jam-packed on what's called River Street.
How many times a year? Every weekend?
No. Just St. Paddy's Day weekend.
Oh, okay.
So it was like the big deal. And so they would have this huge thing where they close it off, and 100,000 people come into this little town. And it was like Mardi Gras where, it was shoulder to shoulder. You waited 2 hours to get a beer. Mm-hmm. There was nowhere to pee,
terrible.
I mean, it was fun when you're a college kid, but not so fun later
So it doesn't sound like a family event or anything
not then. But they made so much money though. And then later on, if you come any other weekend of the year, it's fine for families, but that one's a little nutty. And, but they've calmed it down a lot. Unfortunately, I liked the Wild West.
Wild West.
That kind of drinking environment. Yeah, I mean, I remember...
Isn't that on the East Coast?
I meant the Wild West, as in you could do whatever the heck you wanted.
Okay.
As in, I remember us sitting there, and it was such a strange sensation to be drinking beers and talking to police officers. And we'd
on the
offer
streets?
Them, yeah, we'd offer them our beers. We'd be like, you want a sip?
To say no.
And they were like, no, and they'd smile. But it was so odd to everywhere else you'd get arrested for something like that.
And the world did not end.
No, it's crazy.
And there were still drunks in the streets either way. It's not like people aren't getting drunk and stumbling around in your hometown, even though there is some sort of open container ordinance. It's just a way to pick on people who don't know their rights. It's a way to target young people specifically, because they're more likely to not know their rights and more likely to have an open container of something.
Yeah.
And take advantage of them and extract money from them. That's what it's really about.
A lot of that. But, you know, also when you're young and dumb, you sometimes get completely out of control, people, you know. So I guess a private security force could have handled it just fine to handle the drunks, but...
Yeah, they're good with them, actually.
The city...
Private security is really good, generally, with people that are inebriated. They're trained for that. They know how to handle it. They know to separate people and to, you know, just end the conflict rather than bring the police in a lot of cases.
What blows me away is how much the city pays for that. They have to pay for all the cops to work overtime.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I can't even imagine what it costs to throw something like that.
That was one of the biggest bills that the city had to pay here, or specifically the school here in Keene, New Hampshire, when Pumpkin Fest happened, because they bring in cops everywhere for that. Mike is with us listening in Clackamas, Oregon. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Tarrin, and Mark.
Hey, folks.
Hey, Mike, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi. You guys were just talking about the open container laws, and... I remember when I was living back in New Hampshire, my buddy Pete and I, we used to go up to Waterville Valley, New Hampshire, to watch the fireworks, and there is no open container law up there at all. You can walk around the town square with a beer.
And this way in your town, Mark? There's no open container ordinance?
I don't know. I have no clue.
That's good to know. Okay. I didn't think there was, though.
Yes.
I don't know why anybody would walking around my town with an open container.
Didn't you say, though, that there was like some sort of town barbecue you went to and it was actually on town property and they had alcohol there?
Oh, maybe it was, yeah.
Sorry to interrupt, Mike. Go ahead. It's probably not uncommon in New Hampshire towns.
No worries. So we would go up to Waterville Valley, and it's like at the town square area there, and there's like a lot of shops and touristy attractions, and we'd walk into a, you know, kind of a fancy convenience store and buy a 32-ounce Sam Adams, we'd crack it open and just watch the fireworks. And we'd be walking right in front of the cops. They don't care. So the message to all the cops and all the politicians, if you want to stop all these problems from happening, let up on all these ridiculous laws that restrict just normal activity, you know?
Yeah, that's absolutely true. And that's what happened with a lot of the people during the Pumpkin Fest riots in 2014 here. A lot of those college students were just peeved because the cops were coming around breaking up their fun. They would come and, like, raid parties and throw everybody out into the streets. So they got angry out in the streets and then just started to destroy property. Mike, thanks for your call and thoughts tonight. 855-450-FREE allows you to join us here. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
every once in a while you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm. CopBlock has quickly become the top police accountability group in the United States, and maybe even the world. With chapters across the globe, there's probably a group near you that you can join. If not, you can start your own. Besides joining a local CopBlock group, you can also give just $1 a month to the CopBlock network. Your contribution helps support the efforts of those who make CopBlock possible. So please join the CopBlock network now at copblock.lrn.fm. That's copblock.lrn.fm.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here at 855-450-FREE. Your comments on everything from open container to jury nullification, we've been there tonight. You can, of course, bring up anything that happens to be on your mind. And with you in the studio, joining you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Taryn P. Lupo.
And also, King Mark.
Also, ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Litecoin, and Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They are a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can likely serve you. Sorry, New Yorkers. ExpressCoin.com. You can go there and check them out. They are super easy to use. I have used them to both purchase and to sell Bitcoin. They do them both ways. ExpressCoin.com. Coupon code FTL. Like Free Talk Live, get you up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee. So don't forget coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com.
So ExpressCoin doesn't require you, is my understanding, doesn't require you to have, you know, fill out a bunch of paperwork unless you're up doing business up over some large sum.
Okay.
Is that right?
I don't know.
It's my understanding.
It's been too long since I've used them to buy.
To buy, yeah. And I just wonder if you're sending in a check or a money order, if you're sending in a money order, for instance, how they would know what you where you live.
So, the postmark on the envelope.
Yeah, there could be a postmark on the envelope. I don't know if that is...
It's not proof.
Not proof, really, of much of anything. I mean, you could live in a border town of some place that...
If what you're saying is it possible for someone in New York to somehow do business with ExpressCoin through a little bit of possible maybe labeling an envelope in a certain way? Maybe.
Okay.
I don't know if we want to advocate that, though.
I'm not advocating for it. I'm just wondering, because Bitcoin isn't tied to a geographic area.
That's true.
When you send with Bitcoin wallet, it doesn't say that your wallet's in Korea.
Nothing would prohibit you from having a friend outside of the area send something away to ExpressCoin on your behalf and then transferring the Bitcoin to you afterwards. That's certainly possible.
That's true, too. Yeah.
All right, so ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL. As we continue here, let's talk more about jury nullification. Here's the Denver Post weighing in on a man who was arrested, 56 years old. And by the way, thank you, I guess, to the courts in Denver for doing this, ultimately, because it is going to get this man more publicity for jury nullification than he otherwise would have received had he just simply stood in front of the courthouse on that day. Because they've arrested him now and charged him with 7 felonies. for talking with jurors about their rights as a juror. He's been charged with jury tampering.
And what he was doing shouldn't be any more illegal than a civics class. In a civics class, that's they right. tell you how juries work to some extent. And all he was doing was handing out historical information about juries.
And that's kind of the way FIJA, they pretty much promote that you don't
that's
actually...
That's the fully informed jury association.
Yeah, sorry. They usually tell people if you're going to do this sort of outreach... not to interfere with anyone, just hand it out and say, would you like some information? And that's yep. all you say.
That may have been all he was doing. But either way, they went after him because they found these jurors with his flyer in the courthouse. And I've heard of shenanigans by court personnel that include confiscating jury nullification information. And, of course, making it look like this is contraband and that this is, you know, information that they should not be seeing. Because, well, the man in the robe is saying that this is bad stuff, so you shouldn't see this. Of course, if that were me, it'd make me want to know even more what was in there. But this is definitely going to, I think, backfire for the courts, because now you got the Denver Post, which is a fairly mainstream, you know, media publication there, that is weighing in here. Here's their editorial board in an article entitled, or an editorial entitled, Jury Nullification is Not a Crime, Denver. It's astonishing that Denver police would arrest someone for handing out political literature outside a courthouse. It's even more astonishing that prosecutors would charge that person with 7 felony counts of jury tampering. Yet this is what happened last month to 2 activists. I didn't know it was 2 of them. Who are handing out pamphlets on jury nullification on the pedestrian plaza outside the Lindsay Flanagan Courthouse in Denver. Now, fortunately, civil rights attorney David Lane has filed a lawsuit in federal court on behalf of other jury nullification activists. They want an injunction to stop the city from violating their First Amendment rights should they, too, wish to pass out literature. Good for him. I'm glad to hear there's already been a case filed in this. They deserve to get one, and that is the injunction. Jury nullification is understandably controversial and is especially resented by courts and prosecutors.
Yep, because lawyers believe that they know everything there is to know about the law and you know nothing. And they certainly don't want to give up any kind of monopoly they have.
It is the notion that jurors can ignore the law and follow their conscience when they believe the law would dictate a miscarriage of justice. But it is hardly a new concept. In one of the most celebrated colonial trials, for example, a jury acquitted newspaper editor Peter Zenger of libeling the royal governor, even though Zenger was technically guilty under the law. And the judge basically told the jurors to find him guilty. But they found him not guilty because they have the right to ignore the law and judge based on their conscience. And that's all that this man, age 56, was telling people outside of the courthouse. In one of the, 19th century, northern juries refused to convict abolitionists for harboring runaway slaves.
Yep.
In the 20th century, juries often balked at enforcing prohibition, and later, on occasion, at what they considered overly harsh drug laws, or laws governing sexual behavior.
Now, I think it's worth pointing out here that when they mention the fugitive slave situation in the North, what they chose not to mention here is that in the South there were times when juries wouldn't convict a white person of killing a black person.
Have you read this article? Because that's the next sentence.
Okay.
Jury nullification.
I just like to be fair. Yeah. Like, jury nullification's history isn't all peaches and cream.
Yeah, I mean, it's controversial. Jury nullification had a darker strain, too, as Southern juries would sometimes refuse to convict white defendants guilty of racial violence.
Great. Excellent. I feel that's fair. Good job, editorial board at the Denver.
No, this is a well-written piece here by the Denver Post editorial
board. Denver whatever. Yeah, gotcha.
The point is, jury nullification is not some crank theory concocted out of the blue, and there are plenty of those about courthouses. A First Amendment scholar, Eugene Volca, has written, quote, "It's clear that it's not a crime for jurors to refuse to convict, even when the jury instructions seem to call for a guilty verdict," unquote. Those who believe the public need to know about this possibility should have every right to publicize their views, even outside of a courthouse, maybe especially outside of a courthouse. If not there, near the precincts of American justice, where protests and leafleting of all sorts are an honorable tradition, then where? Where is it appropriate?
Yeah, where would it be appropriate?
Should we be afraid of handing out jury nullification information at Subway? Here in downtown Keene, there's a Subway that's just a short jaunt from the courthouse. It's not uncommon for people to get out of trial and then go out for some lunch or whatever and then come back to trial later.
should, well, you know,
I mean, Subway's a private place.
There's hundreds of years of precedent set on you go protest in front of the courthouse.
Right.
I mean, come on.
But what they were saying, though, Mark, in this case is that this man is guilty of jury tampering because the jury members had his flyer. And so had he been not even standing in front of the courthouse and instead had been standing in front of the Subway near the courthouse and handing flyers to everyone walking by, had he accidentally handed one unknowingly to a juror, then would they also have been able to charge him?
It's a ridiculous charge.
Yeah, it is. Let's see here. The district attorney's office says the two arrested men were targeting actual jury pool members. Yet even if that's true, so what? Asks the editorial board. If they were not advocating a specific course of action in a specific trial, how could they be guilty of trying to influence a juror's vote, which is how Colorado's law defines tampering? Maybe you can explain. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while. But once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Put it to rest. Get a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. We protect your online image by helping to make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771.
Our digital freedom is under attack. Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeross.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget, freeross.org.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Following reports that local full-blown alcoholic Ken Matheson has such great friends that let him drink himself to death right before their eyes, the 32-year-old man spoke to reporters during a typical evening of binging with his closest friends.
Man, these guys are like brothers to me. I don't know what I'd do without them.
The chemically dependent man who can reportedly always count on his friends to look the other way, facilitate belligerent behavior, and encourage his self-destructive impulses informed reporters that the members of his tight-knit circle are, quote, the best buddies a guy could ask for.
Can you just shut the fuck up? Seriously, just shut the fuck up. I lost the fuck back then. Keep going. What the fuck are you looking at? I love you, man. I love you.
Check this week's Onion Review for further developments.
I love you. Oh, God, I love everybody.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us here. Maybe you can explain why jury nullification is tantamount to jury tampering. I really would love to hear that, because not even the federal court district judge agrees with that. We'll tell you a little bit more about what's happening with apparently what was two men. This story here over at Denver Post, and I would figure that the Denver Post is likely to get this right. I mean, the Raw story was telling us about one guy who is in his 50s. Apparently two people were arrested, according to this, for handing out jury nullification information in front of a courthouse there in Denver. It's just absolutely outrageous, and the Denver Post is spot on in their editorial excoriating the court system for doing this and the prosecutors. Pro-XPN is what you need if you care about privacy and you're online in any way, shape, or form, whether it's your smartphone, whether it's your laptop, your desktop computer, your tablet, whether you've got Android, iOS, Mac, Windows, Linux. You can get Pro-XPN working for you. It's a virtual private network. They encrypt your online data, and they do it right, offering OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption. Plus, unlike those other guys, Pro-XPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever. Now Pro-XPN has more servers than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. They accept credit card and Bitcoin. You can get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account when you buy an annual account with our code, FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 like 50% off. You can break the price down to less than a good cup of coffee. For protection, online, proxpn.com. Go there now, use code FTL50, and take back the privacy that is your right. Just a little bit more here from the Denver Post about the men who were arrested in Colorado facing felony charges for handing out jury nullification information. They point out here in the last couple paragraphs of their article that the district attorney's office says the two arrested men were targeting actual jury pool members. But even if that were true, so what? If they were not advocating a specific course of action in a specific trial, how could they be guilty of trying to influence a juror's vote as Colorado's law defines tampering? Their jury nullification literature, as it happens, merely offered general statements, such as, quote, jury nullification is your right to refuse to enforce bad laws and bad prosecutions, unquote. That does not say that, sir, the case you're sitting on is a bad law. You need to acquit this man. Again, that would be jury tampering.
Again, this is no more jury tampering than civics class where they tell you about juries. Yeah. This is juror education. And that's
which
fine.
The court does too, by the way. They usually make you watch some stupid video about being a jury or juror when you go in there. So they're propagandizing too.
Well, the court is going to claim that they have a monopoly over that, yep. And that's not a problem. But what they need to do is they need to be consistent. If they're going to go after one group of people that educates jurors, they need to go after every group that is not the court that educates jurors. Now, you may
they
say
won't
that,
do that
the government schools is the, you know, the same as the government court because they're both the same organization. Well, that's fine. I had civics in a private school. So are you going to arrest the private school social studies teachers? Because that's what you need to do next if you're going to enforce this bullcrap arrest.
4 years ago, prosecutors in New York City charged a retired chemistry professor. This is Julian Heichlin that you were talking about earlier.
Was he making?
Tarrin.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought he was making math. Go ahead.
No, he was passing out information with jury tampering after he stood outside a federal courthouse handing out information on jury nullification. But Judge Kimba M. Wood of Federal District Court wouldn't buy it. She ruled that prosecutors needed to show that the protester meant to influence jurors in a specific case and dismissed all charges. So I expect that if there's any semblance of justice left, and there may not be. But if there
sorry to hear that, buddy.
Any semblance of it, this charge should be dropped before it even gets to trial. This is likely the tactic that they've used on Julian Heichlin a zillion times, which is arrest the protester, charge him with some BS, later on drop the charges, and then call it a day.
Yep.
You've gotten the protester out of your hair.
That's what they really want. They want to stop the man from giving out information to those poor, vulnerable jurors right there, right then. And that's what the arrest can accomplish. And even with the dozens of arrests, I mean, dozens of arrests that Julian Heiklin was subjected to at these various different federal court facilities, I don't think he ever was able to countersue them.
I think he didn't. I feel like, or maybe am I mixing up with James Babb? Didn't James Babb win one of those?
I don't recall.
No, I feel like one of the guys did. Yeah.
Well, but if anybody recalls that detail, please call in. Let us know who has actually won this, because I've never heard of anybody getting any kind of justice for these arrests. Mark Schmidter in Florida was charged with contempt of court. Now, apparently they also charged him with jury tampering, but this summary article I was reading about Schmidter earlier said that he was convicted without a trial. So that says to me that they must have dropped the tampering charge and convicted him with the contempt charge.
The contempt charge, yeah.
Because you can sentence somebody in most places, and I believe Florida is the same way, up to 6 months. A judge can hit you 6 months for contempt. Up to that amount, the judge has no obligation to justify it to anyone besides himself. There's no one overseeing that decision. There's no
appealing it. It's an incredible power.
Yes, it's huge.
The maximum sentence for a misdemeanor is a year. So 6 months on a contempt charge is basically, I mean, it's an incredible power that they have, and no one questions it at all.
No, it's just part and parcel of the Western court system is that judges have the power to hit you with contempt. And that can mean all kinds of things. What's that? You're wearing a hat in court? Contempt. Oh, you've spoken out of turn? Contempt. I mean, there's anything the judge sees you do that he doesn't like that is somehow an interference with the decor in the courtroom? Contempt.
Yeah.
And then it's just up to the judge how many days in jail you get to spend. 180 is a six-month sentence. So share your thoughts here on jury nullification. There's actually something I wanted to come back to. I promised I would do this. About getting permission. This is one of the things I really disagreed with our caller earlier. I think it was Tom from Maryland who had called in. He was calling. He was the former cop who'd spent a lot of time in courtrooms. Mm-hmm. And I think he's got some interesting stories to tell, and I've enjoyed his input to the show. But I don't agree that you should ask permission to go and do jury nullification outreach, because when you ask permission to do that, it's almost always going to be no.
They're government bureaucrats. Their answer to everything is no.
Or even if you can get them to say yes eventually after weeks likely of being passed around from one bureaucracy to another, oh, it's not my department, you have to call so-and-so, those, you know, getting the runaround. If you finally accomplish getting some sort of permission to do this, they're going to put you in a free speech zone where they'll arbitrarily define some place over by the dumpster that you get to hang out and do your outreach. Oh, wait, no one walks by that location?
So what? Well, you have your ability to pass out the pamphlet, and now you are violating their rules because they've given you, you know, they've given you orders.
Yeah, they'll give you some sort of agreement that you have to make or something like that. You do not want to go and ask permission to do this. Now, the reason why Tom was saying that was because the risks are involved, right? Like, if you go to do jury nullification outreach and you're alone, that's a very risky, risky environment. Unless you have pre-paved, if you will, sort of put yourself out there with others there, and you've gone out with multiple people and you've done outreach at the same courthouse for a period of time where you feel like you can handle that by yourself, like that you've established sort of the precedent of doing that there, I think you can do it in that case. But if you're new to a courthouse, if you've never been there before, you've never done outreach of any sort at that courthouse, bring friends with you. Bring video cameras and friends with you. Don't go this alone. If you can get more than two to come out with you, then that's good. The more, the merrier, as far as I'm concerned. Because that's one of the greatest protections you have against the police harassing you. Those cops don't want to be on YouTube. They don't want to. And if they see people hanging around you with multiple video cameras slung off their arms, they're going to think twice or three times before they even decide to come over and say word one to you.
Right. They're going to be like, you want me to go out and check on them? You go out and check on them. They're going to be arguing amongst themselves who has to be the YouTube villain.
And remember, another reason not to get permission is because if you ask for permission, you've given away your rights. It's your right to freedom of speech. You have to exercise it to have that right. And in order to exercise rights, you are putting yourself at risk. It's a fact. Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE.
every once in a while you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government when you can be truly independent with Liberty HealthShare, a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care? Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. Liberty HealthShare. Together, we are one.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, the final moments. We've got time for you. If you dial in right now, 855-450-FREE, that's how you can join us here. The us is me, Ian.
And Tarrin P. Lupo.
And Mark.
Tarrin's here courtesy of his website, TarrinLupo.com. Our site, FreeTalkLive.com. Enjoy that. Also coming up, Keenvention. Tarrin, you're going to be hosting one of the panels at Keenvention. It's about new movers.
I'm excited.
To New Hampshire. Mostly as part of the Free State Project. People who have picked up their lives, as you have done, within the last year. That's the qualification, generally, to be on the new movers panel. You got to be pretty new. And you know, what is life? What is life like as somebody who's fresh? Somebody who's you know, it's not your first time in New Hampshire. You visited here a number.
Yeah,
of times.
But it's a different story living here.
Sure is.
Learning all the ropes and how y'all got these crazy roundabouts.
I don't know how different.
I don't know how those things
work. You
know,
the funny thing is, Tarrin, when I went back down to Florida, those roundabouts had popped up everywhere.
They're starting to move south.
There's a lot of them down there now.
They're a good idea. You don't have to sit at a stoplight. Yeah,
really
you've
got
to get used to sort of merging into a roundabout.
It's confusing as heck where you get in and out.
It doesn't take too long to figure it out. But anyway, come to Keenvention. You can see Taryn's panel and learn from the newbies. You can also watch the old school panel, which Dennis Goddard's going to be hosting. And learn from the people who've been here forever. There's also something like not quite a dozen panels that have already been sort of formed. I haven't announced all of them yet, but they're coming. Those announcements are coming. If you want to find out the latest about who's speaking at Keenvention, it's coming up October 30th through November 1st. You can go to keenvention.info, and you can see all of the announcements that have been made thus far. I got the Cop Block panel is going to be announced next, and the host of that. So if you want to stay tuned, Keenvention.info has the blog. It's got the most info on it. There's also our Keenvention Facebook page. Keenvention is your opportunity to come to New Hampshire, specifically to come to Keene and to experience what it's like to be around other people who actually care about freedom and who are willing to do something about it. We focus on activism. We bring the people to the front of the room who are the New Hampshire-based liberty activists, the people who are, in my opinion, the most important doers in the world for liberty at the moment. I mean, it's great to have big name speakers at some of these liberty events, but we don't do that at Keenvention. We keep it focused on the activism. I try to get the names from the activism world, but those aren't that's not celebritarian status necessarily. So I think it's the content that's important at Keenvention, not necessarily the big stars. So come on out and join us for an intimate convention where you might learn a thing or two about activism. And, of course, you can also go and watch 2013, 2014. You want to see what it was like on stage there? You can watch the whole thing over at keenvention.info. Tickets are just $60 for the entire weekend. Go find a convention anywhere for less than $100 for a ticket. I don't think you can do it.
No.
All right. Dare.
Keenvention.info. Let's go to Mark. He's in Orlando, Florida. Mark, you're on Free Talk Live.
I was listening, or I heard that you had Mark kind of selling down there.
I'm sorry, are you on like a speakerphone or a headset or something like that?
No, I'm on a regular phone.
Okay, all right, go ahead.
I'm on a cell phone, but the speaker's off.
All right, what were you calling about?
Mark, about jury nullification.
Yes, what about it?
Well, anyhow, I was the one that was arrested by Judge Belvin Perry, did 103 days in jail.
You're Mark Schmidter. Oh, welcome welcome back on the show, Mark. We were real unclear. I'm glad you called in. Thanks to whoever gave you the heads up. But we were real unclear on exactly how everything shook out with your case. You were charged initially with jury tampering, correct? Did that charge get dropped in favor of just hitting you with contempt? What happened there?
No, I got two charges. One was I was convicted for not being in the free speech zone. That was 151 days in jail. And then the flyer was 146 days in jail.
But those aren't charges. Is that criminal contempt?
Well, he called it criminal contempt because I violated his administrative order. I didn't violate any law or ordinance.
Right. So you weren't actually charged with jury tampering. You were charged with criminal contempt.
Yeah. Well, it was criminal contempt of court, but it's in his administrative order. He wrote it in there as jury tampering,
right.
But I didn't violate the law of jury tampering.
Which is why they didn't charge you with it.
Well, it was in his administrative order.
Yeah, but that's not the same thing. Just because a judge says, oh, well, I'll consider this jury tampering, doesn't mean that it actually is, right? Because if it had been a jury tampering charge, you would have gotten a jury. You would have been able to explain to the jury the rules of jury nullification. You've been able to present the flyer that you were handing out to people, and it would have been an amazing trial. Unfortunately, he short-circuited that by basically saying, well, you disobeyed my administrative order, so that's contempt. And then he put you in jail for over 100 days.
That'd be correct.
And
yeah.
You continue to go and hand out. We were told earlier that you're going back to hand out flyers regularly at this courthouse. I got to commend you for your courage. Why do you think they've left you alone? since then?
Oh, no, no, that ain't quite right. That was at Orange County Courthouse. But for the last 4 years, I've been handing them out every Monday morning up in Sanford, just north of Orlando, at the Seminole County Criminal Justice Center.
Oh, I see. Okay, Seminole County, is that a different county from Orlando?
It's a tiny little county that was cut out of Orange at one point.
So basically, okay, so what I misunderstood was is that you're not going back to the same courthouse where you were arrested. You're going to a courthouse where apparently they're more tolerant of you?
Yeah. Actually, it's only Orange County Courthouse is the only courthouse in the country, except from what I heard from Mark Inicelli, that now it's Denver, but that's a new one.
Yeah, that's the guy you're referring to, the guy that Tarrin was telling us about earlier, the 56-year-old man who was arrested. Apparently, there was a second person arrested as well. We didn't get that person's name for handing out jury nullification information. Regardless, Mark, I mean, the fact that you're going to any courthouse after having been arrested at one for doing this and continuing to hand out this information is a truly courageous act because they could certainly target you anytime, obviously, and thank you for continuing to do that. Very important outreach. Was there anything else you wanted to share with our audience tonight?
Well, what it is after spending the time in jail, I was really empowered when I came out. So I still hand out the flyers every morning, and I have a Facebook site on there, Fully Informed Jury Association Florida. But the main thing I'm working on now with what time I have left is the common law grand juries. We're reconstituting those throughout the state.
Well, that's interesting. If that actually pans out, because we've heard people call about this common law jury, and it just sounds more like theorizing than anything else. But if it actually turns into something, I'd love to hear you call in and tell us more about it. Would you do that?
Yeah, and just briefly, what we did is we filed one in federal court, and now what we've done is the common law grand jury, when I say we, I mean they put a lien on Rick Scott's personal house and also Pam Bondi's personal house for $2 billion each.
It sounds like it's going to be interesting.
Yeah, I have to say that's it's very unusual. Thank you, Mark, for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Oh, by the way, how's your appeal going?
Well, the appeal is dead because I had a lawyer working on it, but he dropped out. And I believe the reason he dropped out is somebody called him up and said, if you ever want to win a case here, you better drop.
How do you even appeal contempt of court? I didn't even know that was possible.
Well, actually, we did appeal it, and the Fifth District Court of Appeals in December of 12 threw out the free speech zone as unconstitutional. But then they reaffirmed Judge Belvin Perry in his favor and against me, saying that Orange County Courthouse is not an open forum, meaning it's private property, so therefore the administrative judge, Belvin Perry, can do anything he wants because it's private property.
Wow.
Did you ask them if you had to continue paying property taxes to keep this private thing going?
Well, you know, I didn't ask him that because when he resentenced me and actually told me in open court that, well, Mr. Schmidter, I have to make an example out of you because my judges told me they're losing too many cases because of the flyer you're handing out.
Ridiculous.
You're in charge of jury nullification Florida. How many counties is jury nullification happening in there?
For all that I know, I'm the only one that's doing it.
Oh, man. I'm sorry to hear about that, Mark.
Yeah, come on up.
Yeah, you got to get to New Hampshire one of these days. We've got now 6 or 7 out of 10 counties here doing jury nullification outreach on a regular basis. Thanks for the call tonight. Really appreciate hearing from you. Of course, if you're interested in learning more about New Hampshire, you should go to freestateproject.org. If you love liberty, if you don't love liberty, then just stay right where you are.
Just ignore that.
Jeff in Elgin, Illinois, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Jeff.
Hi, you guys. My dad used to fight speeding tickets, and this is before they would search people when you go into court. So he would actually take a cassette recorder and put it, he'd open up his shirt and put it under his shirt.
A great big
6-volt battery. And that was kind of funny to think about that, you know, we used to do that. I don't think they allow you to tape or video the courts, but,
Well, it depends on where you are. In New Hampshire, we got no problem recording video in courtrooms. It's the courthouses where they've been cracking down over the last several years, every now and then, on people with cameras.
Can sign up to come to New Hampshire at freestateproject.org.
That's true. Thanks, Jeff. We're short on time. You'll have to call tomorrow night if you got more to say. But back tomorrow, online in the meantime, at freetalklive.com. Don't forget Taryn's site, TarrinLupo.com. He's got videos.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, August 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.97 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,123 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. Antiwar.com reports 75 experts from the Arms Control Association have come out Tuesday with a statement to endorse the P5+1 nuclear deal with Iran, saying the pact was a net plus for nuclear nonproliferation and exceeds historical standards on arms control limitations. The signatories of the statement include several high-profile opponents of the 2003 U.S. invasion of Iraq, including Joe Wilson and Valerie Plame, along with former IAEA chief Hans Blix and former U.S. Ambassador Morty Halperin. The statement goes on to echo the comments of other proponents, saying it would make it easy for the international community to detect any clandestine program by Iran and will decisively prevent Iran from acquiring a nuclear weapon. Congress is planning to vote on the deal on September 17th and is expected to have a majority against the deal. It is not, however, expected to get the veto-proof majority that would be needed to attempt to block U.S. participation in the pact outright. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and